Okay, so I mean we've had a couple of sessions before already, so I guess what changed since the last session?
I mean, I feel like my mechanics have improved. I feel like my matchup knowledge has improved. It's just when I entered Silver, for some reason, it was I just didn't begin to do as well as I did when I was in Bronze. I don't know why. I don't know if I was
You think it's a
if
mental
I was playing
thing?
worse. I don't know really. That's the thing, because I played quite a few games over quite a few days to try and change my mental. Recently, I've been getting some success, but like if you look far back enough, there's a lot of defeats and very few victories.
Well, so you just recently dropped out of silver or what?
Oh no, I haven't dropped out of silver. I think I'm still in silver.
Okay, it's not updated then. Yeah,
I've
okay.
just like I just had like two wins, so I was able to stay back in silver. But it's been a tough like road with these sort of games. There were games where I was fully like meant to carry the game, but then the whole team charges me down and then runs down the entire team and they just die. So that's been quite a challenge.
Okay. Yeah, I
And
think
there's one game where I was.
yeah, this time around, I want to do it a little bit differently. I want to look at a game of yours first, and then we go into a live game. I just want to see where you're at, and then maybe I can already give you some tips. I've seen that there's good coaches that do it this way around, and I think it definitely makes some sense. I mean, of course, we've had a bunch of sessions before together, so it's not like, but still, like for sure, things change and whatever, and I also don't fully remember what exactly your biggest problems were. Do you remember what I told you last time? What your
I
like biggest
mean,
weaknesses were?
I've seen some of the previous videos, and you said to me one of the things was pushing towers. Another thing you said to me was trying to keep your farm up, which I have been trying to, but after a certain point, it's very hard when they're just getting run down and you need to be in the fights. And the other thing is, this was from the first session. There were quite a few basic things like using my W and things like that, but I think
But
I've
have you
improved.
improved on that? Yeah, okay. I mean,
I
that's definitely
think.
something we'll see in like there's one game here that stands out to me. You had 23 kills,
Yes,
but you
that's the
didn't
one I
win.
was really irritated about, because that game was when I was meant to carry my whole team, but for some reason, all five of them come on top of me, and then I just die, and I could not win the game. It's very, I don't know how. It's just like certain champions, like for me, Olaf can just run the whole team down, and it's really hard to play against him, not
I
gonna lie.
mean, Olaf, for example, you just need to respect him, you know? You really just do. Like, all you need to do with him, throw your Qs, wait for the passive procs, or like passive stacks to play, and then proc it with you. Like, there's nothing more. You will get beat down even if he's like one or even two items behind, then he will still just beat you in like a fist fight, but because that's the champ, you know? And it's the same with Master Yi, it's the same with Warwick. Like, all of these champs, you really just need to respect them, and like, you re really need to, like, maybe. I don't think you have like a big ego, but like for me personally, for example, I've noticed after like coming back from the break, like how many plays I went for because of like bad ego decisions, basically, where I was like, yeah, I'm sure he's not gonna kill me, even though I kind of knew that it was like the wrong decision. So you really
I didn't know
just.
the Olaf, because when I went into Olaf in fights, it's the fact that he has so much lifesteal. It makes it very hard for him to kill.
But you
It's
know
the
that,
same with
no?
Belveth,
Yeah,
Warwick.
but don't you know that? So just respect it. Like, you can play against these champs, but you can play against every single champ in the game with Ekko. You just need to play differently against certain champs. And, like, against these high DPS champs that are close ranged, of course, because they're also high DPS, they might be too tanky for you to one-shot. You really just need to accept that you will never be able to really 1v1 them. But that's what you have a team for. And yes, I know, like, in Bronze, you really don't have that much of a team, but I'm more than sure that like they also make big mistakes that you're just not punishing, you know? And
I mean, I've been trying to get objectives and things, but like when the whole team like moves towards the objective and my team doesn't respond at all to the objectives, it's kind of
Yeah, I
like
think objectives should probably not even be a focus for you, and they really probably shouldn't be. I think what like I'm gonna share my screen already to just look at the OPGG a little bit. Like, we can. This is the same account you always used to play on. You just renamed it.
yeah, it's
Okay.
I just renamed.
So like Look, in your last couple of games, you have not broken 6 CS per minute a single time, and like, okay, here you did it once, but like, this is just like, I'm 100% certain I've told you this before, but just like, the game is so, so, so much more difficult when you play on these low CS numbers, you know? And like, yeah, sure, in games that go long, the CS might drop off towards the end, but they should still be around like 7 CS per minute or whatever, especially in winning games, you know? Like, they really shouldn't be at 5. And then another big thing is, like, your deaths. I think these are, like, the highest average deaths I've probably ever seen from someone that I've coached. It's really, really high. Like, way too high. It's, like, Echo has every single, like, his passive and, like, all of his spells, they're literally all have some amount of defensive value. So not dying on Echo should be quite easy. And I'm sure with you especially, it's probably a lot of it is probably down to decision-making. I would say, but let's see also your stats. See, like, also duels win rate. I mean, I've seen worse for sure, but still, it means like basically half the fights you take, you lose. And you're an Echo millionaire, so yeah, you have a decent amount of mastery points, right? You have played the champ, so you should be able to win more duels or like not take so many duels that are like that you are losing, you know? Do you feel like you're actively thinking when you're playing?
Yeah, I mean, if you look at that 23-10 game, there were quite a few decisions that I don't know if you that were different that I wouldn't have done, but I did, and it worked out really well initially.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I managed to like do really well up to like a certain point where it would just run me down.
We'll definitely take a look at this game. I'm very curious to see. I mean, it's a 40-minute game, but I think we'll still have some time for a live game afterwards. We're just not going to review the live game then. That's okay with you. I think this kind of game, like, it is definitely one that's very interesting. So yeah, let's keep looking at this, I guess, as well. See, like, for example, this, like, Warwick is just not a champ you should be losing, and this already tells me that you probably just don't play correctly against him. You know, the fact that you lose so many times. But I'm more than certain that I've told you specifically before how to play. And that's why I'm asking with, like, the active thinking, because I noticed myself, like, when I'm not actively thinking, I'm just making all of these mistakes that lead to, like, not respecting and whatever.
I tend to, initially, they would, like, gank, the Warwick could gank, like, 3 times. They probably would get kills during that time. And that just puts him way ahead of me while I'm trying to CS, because my laners just did not do as well. So, and then when it comes to going in, he just invades me. I try to run away, he queues, and I die. That's essentially what most of the time happens. But,
I mean, this is not the Warwick game, but this is the game where we'll see how you played against the Olaf, I guess, especially. A big thing I've also realized, I guess, or like, I watched some, like, jungle guide yesterday for the first time in however long, and I've realized, like, the way you need to be thinking about the game is really way more in terms of golden experience and not so much in like terms of farm and ganking, you know? So if you see something on the map and you're certain that you can get it, then go there, right? Like, get the kill. Because your farm is the thing that you can always fall back on. And that's like a big mindset you really need to adopt. And I've just heard this yesterday. I still need to apply all this stuff myself. But I think, like, this is how you become like an actually good jungler. And also think of the game way more in like a 1v1, what's the right word? Like, think of it as like a 1v1 mentality against the enemy jungle. Like, really don't, of course, care about the lanes. Like, look, for example, like a Volibear, you might be able to gank, maybe not the Olaf or whatever, but like, really think about it in terms that you want to crush your enemy jungle. You know, you really want to, like, as soon as you get a lead, you want to crush them, you want to maybe take something away from them and whatever. And, like, that's not the main thing you really need to focus on in your current elo, but it's just something you need to understand, you know? Because, like, of course, you're telling me that the Warwicks, they do invade you. Like, probably they invade you in situations where they shouldn't even be able to, but it's still, like, that's why they do sometimes maybe crush you, you know? And even though they're also bronze players, or, like, silver players.
Yeah. There was a decision right off the bat, after I finished my red camps, that I did, because she started blue side.
Mm-hmm. See, already, like, here, this is the kind of stuff, it really doesn't matter, but it shows me something about you, you know, the fact that you don't hit all of them here, because it's such a simple thing, you know, it really is so simple to just hit all of them, and you stand here, you throw the Q out, right, and I'm sure that, like, these are the small inefficiencies that they will just add up, you know, and they're the inefficiencies that, yes, they don't matter a whole lot, but they're so easy to fix, you know, and, like, you really need to start caring about this stuff. Just the fact that, like, you could stand here and then also you waited for, like, 2 seconds for no reason. Like, sure, it's only 2 seconds, but out of 1 minute and 32 seconds, 2 seconds is not even that small of an amount. And then, yeah, only hit the big one, you know? You really only need to hit the big one. This is taking way longer than it has to. And then another, like, thing, I've also not done this for a long time, but do the Crux second if you do the Raptor's Path. Do Crux second so they're sequenced together, you know, because now, especially in the early game, of course, it takes you a long time, you know, you start at 150, let's see when you're gonna be done here. See, it takes you like 25 seconds, that means this camp will respawn 25 seconds later, you know, which is not what you want to happen, because, like, on the second time you're around here, you might just be able, like, if you only have to, like, sure, and most times you might not fully full clear, but if you want to fully full clear, then you won't be able to, because this camp's just not going to be up, and it's just going to make your, like, overall CS lower, and it's just awkward. And then the other thing is, like, first of all, it's really not slower if you do the red buff there. It really isn't. Then another thing is, like, if you would be getting late invaded, it's actually better to just skip the red buff and do it as a third camp. It's just safer, because the people will just be here, and they might even be confused in your ELA especially, but, like, they will be in this brush and nothing will be happening for them. Like, they either start or they wait. Like, sure, if they actually have the patience to wait, then they might be able to punish. But most of the time, they probably just start it because they think you're on the other side of the map or something. And, of course, if you're here, you have a much easier time going mid, you know, if there's an opportunity there. So, like, if you're here, you really just can only go bot, basically. Like, that you would spend a lot of time walking back here. So if you end like, you're clearing here, you can just, it's basically the same. You can still go bot and you can go mid, so it's just better. Like, just start doing that in your future games, for sure.
I'll do it in my future games.
And let's see how much gold you have here. Like, also, get this, right? You know, definitely.
I remember doing this.
See, like, and take this. Why should... Okay, yeah, okay. At least you took it. But see, like, you should be finished at, like, 350 gold, basically. And what are you doing now? Are you not even recalling?
No.
Okay. I think, like, if you want to do the, like, then there's, like, no reason why you wouldn't have just gotten a leash here, you know? If you want to full clear. Because your bot team was even ready to leash you, you know? They genuinely were ready to leash you.
I'm not full clearing right now. I'm not full clearing.
What else are you doing then? I mean, if anything, you should be going top right now. Is that what you're doing?
No, I'm actually invading.
That's also fine, I guess. But also, for invading, it's better to have a leash for timing, you know? See, she's already kind of done here. So, if you had gotten a leash and you would have done Red, Crux, Raptors, you would have actually caught her, like, much better. Like, you could still kind of catch her here, maybe, but I assume that could also be because she's a little bit slow. Yeah, okay. I mean, that's good, but, like, generally, this timing, I don't think it should be happening. I think she's just too slow with her clear. You know, like, if she was better, I think she would have already been at the Crux, and then you would... Like, I'm not 100% sure on that, but I know that for going... If you want to go for an invade like this, it's better to go Red, Crux, Raptors, because, again, like, you spent this time walking down just to walk it up again, you know? So if you had started here and just been here, then you 100% would have been there a little bit faster, and, like... Sure, it worked out. That's good. And I think going for invades is something I will also start doing way more. I think you can against these kind of weak early junglers. Okay, like this flash.
I mean, if they start blue, and if I know they're a weak jungler early to begin with, like a Kayn or Lilia, for example, then I do invade, and it works out.
I don't think Kayn is a very weak early jungle, but... Or, like, it's... Kayn is not the, like, strongest early jungler, but also he's not super easy to punish, you know? He can just Q over a lot of the walls, he can just E through the walls, so... It's like, unless he makes big mistakes, he shouldn't die. In your Elo, they will make big mistakes, but of course, I want to teach you the game in a way where, like, we're not focused on the fact that you still get away with so much bullshit in your Elo, because, like, at some point it will just stop, you know? Like, at some point people will just stop making these very big mistakes, and then it won't work, so I will still tell you if something is not necessarily correct. And, like, for example here, like, no reason to flash. I don't, like, you literally flashed on the spot. You wasted a 5-minute cooldown.
I really thought that she would get away. That's why I flashed.
Okay, but, like, so many things here. Again, W. First thing, W completely missing. Now that she flashed over, before going over, place your W here. Like, that's the most likely. This pretty likely, right? This doesn't take, like, too much experience to understand that she's probably just gonna run to her tower. So place a W here, then that's gonna slow her enough anyways. Then if you have really good awareness, you know, she has the red buff on her, so she's a little bit slowed. And then, of course, like, I don't know why you're so scared. Like, see, first of all, now you reapplied the red buff, so she is slowed. And then you will have your Q again in 4 seconds. You know, and instead of flashing, just, like, place your W here now, maybe, and then you can still flash, you know, if you don't get her, but this is what I mean, like, patience is so, so, so important. And, like, at any stage in the game, of course, the later the game goes, the more important patience is, but, like, take this camp.
I saw Yasuo's, I didn't take the camp because I thought I wanted to immediately go to base, because if they collapse...
That's something you can do as well. You can recall here as well. And then you'll be very strong at crap. But it's already kind of late for that. Like, the best time, that's another thing I learned, is, like, at 3 minutes is a... If it's, like, 3 minutes or, like, a couple of seconds after 3 minutes, it's a very good time to base, especially if you get an early kill like this. Just so you can contest crap with extra items in your inventory. I think in this situation it would have been best to get the Crux. Like, first of all, it would have given you level 4. And then also, we have full info, right? Like, the Olaf can't even come, he's way too low. He would literally just die. And then the Yasuo, like, we see him here as well, you know? And if he would be coming, it would take him a long time.
Yeah, he tries to chase me in this, after this.
Okay. Well, yeah, but if you would have just done this, you just go here, you maybe even, like, maybe even the right place to go top here, because this guy is for sure killable. Yeah. I mean, he...
I didn't see that, actually. That was my fault.
Yeah, so you... One thing I, one good habit, I guess, is to look at the minimap after every auto attack. Like, literally after every auto attack, just take a quick look at the minimap and see if there's any info you want to get, you know? See, for example, if two champions are very close to each other, that then look there, or just, yeah, like I mean, that's the main thing you want to see, and then you will see, then you get more information by actually looking there, right? Like, getting the HP and whatever. So, if you're in this kind of position, like, for sure you need to look here, no matter what. You need to see their movement anyways, you need to see if this guy is going to run to you or whatever, and now if you have this info, for example, you can make the decision, like, if he wants to come, then he will probably die, you know? Yeah. So, it's like, and then getting this extra camera would have been very good here, I think, because it would have given you level 4, and then also... I think, yeah, you could have recalled right after gotten Blasting Wand Dark Seal, and that would have been amazing. And then you just go back to your top set, I guess. Maybe even punish the Olaf if he doesn't manage to get out of lane. But this is just too passive, you know?
Yasuo was moving.
Yasuo is literally wasting his time. Like, he should not be... Like, he's not achieving anything here except for annoying you a little bit, right? It's literally just losing minions, so this is not good what he's doing. And you really don't need to be this scared, honestly. I mean, it's a little bit unlucky that you don't have Smite, so if you had Smite, you could have just gotten this. But at the same time, it's also only the first crab anyway, so who cares?
Yeah.
I think next time, just run down here, though. Like, make him commit harder if he actually is gonna keep chasing you like an idiot. And then also, again, you've said this to me, that I have told you specifically your W usage, but, like, why are you not just using your W here? What are you saving it for? Literally, place your W here, and then he will probably just turn around. Like, he kind of has to turn around. And then, like, maybe even ping for help, ping your Yone, and then if he wants to keep playing like an idiot, he will literally die because your Yone is probably gonna move. Maybe even your Volibear can move if the chase goes up here or something, but, like, really just your W is completely missing here. Your W would have secured you the crap. 100%. Like, it's... Just understand that as soon as you place your W, people can't attack you, basically. Or they do, like, of course some champions can with like movement spells or whatever, they can attack you and then use their movement spell to get out of it, but a champ like Yasuo, he might be able to dash through you or whatever, but still, like, he can't really attack you. He will have to move out of your W unless he wants to get stunned, you know? So, yeah. Like, this alone makes the W such a powerful zoning tool. So you, and then, of course, after, you will get the shields for, like, 2 seconds. So then you can fight another 2 seconds basically for free, you know? Like, sure, you won't win a 1v1 here. You won't. Like, you're half HP. This guy's a lethal tempo. He has Ignite. Yes, he will win if you actually commit to it, but you don't need to hard commit. You can just place your W here, maybe finish off the crab, maybe even bait him into the Yone or whatever, and then it's like even worse for the Yasuo because he can't even go back to lane, you know? So this, like, it's just too passive.
Okay.
Or like too scared, I guess. And then again, if you would have just done what would have probably been best to just like clear the Crux, then you just recall the Yasuo would never have come there. Like, if he actually goes here, then he's like, you imagine like how hard he would be committing to the Crux then, like to walking here for like a very low chance of catching you. Would be such a big misplay by him, honestly. And then also, again, like, look how this Olaf is playing. He literally did not even realize that you killed Illilia here, basically. So you could have killed this guy 100%. Let's rewind a little bit more even. You see, like, not a single step back or whatever after you killed Illilia. He just didn't care. He just kept playing basically here, so you could have just walked in behind and killed him completely for free. And then, like, game is basically over for them if you keep snowballing correctly. And then another thing I want to say also, what I learned when I watched the video yesterday, is to really think of the map as 12 camps, you know? Okay. Think of it as 12 camps, that means, like, these three camps and these ones. So it means, yes, six of them are, like, basically secure for you, you know?
Yeah.
But every single other camp that you get is just, is basically a bonus. And it doesn't matter, like, if you get yours. It's, of course, it's better if you get the enemy camps. So, like, here, on this, like, clear, on this, like, first clear, you would have been at seven camps if you clear everything. And she would have only been at five. And, like, this is the kind of stuff how you slowly build up a lead, you know? And then, of course, there's crabs, there's objectives, and whatever. Like, this is more high-level stuff, I guess, to really think about in this way. But I think just having heard of this, because I haven't heard of this this concept, but I think it really makes a lot of sense to me. So maybe you're not going to be able to fully apply it or whatever, but that's not the important stuff. I still wanted to tell you what you buy here. Would you not have bought an Amtom Blasting Wand? I don't think so.
I always go for a Blasting Ward.
So you were actually missing exactly this gold, right? And then also being level 4 already here would have been better, so you... Like, again, now I think you should just be looking top and see if this guy keeps staying, like, here. Maybe, I guess he dies, maybe? Okay, he dies before you're there.
I was going to move there, and then I saw him die, so...
Yeah, and I think here, you definitely, like, especially because top just died, you shouldn't start at Wolves. But even if, I don't think there's any scenario where you want to start at Wolves here, clearing. Okay. You need to go for the crab, first of all, because, like, yeah, you might think it's cleared, but if you actually look at the map, you see that Lilia's bot, so since you just recalled from here where the crab was up, you know, you should know that it's still up. And even if it isn't, you might even catch the Lilia there or something, and she only has an Amptom. And then you want to path down here because top just died. Or help your top push, maybe. But I think he will manage himself, actually, because of the passive. So I don't even think you need to do that. Okay, that's good. At least you sequence these camps together. And like, this is... I definitely used to overvalue this a little bit, I have to say. It's not the end of the world to clear, like, up here. But also, there's no reason for you, you know? Like, the important thing is to clear these camps together. It's not super important if you start here or if you start here. It really isn't, because most of the time you're not going to be at the camp on spawn anyways. So you did the most important thing right, at least you cleared them in a sequence. But I think generally, because the crab is the contested area and you should know that it's up, I think you should just go there anyways and then path down. Like, path down, obviously look mid the whole time, see if there's something happening here.
That's what I was doing.
Okay, I think, for example, here you should not be looking mid. Like, I mean, you should be looking mid, but you shouldn't be moving there, because look, this guy is already as far away as possible, basically. So how are you gonna reach him? Like,
yeah.
You won't without Rocket Belt anyway. So now, like, even with Rocket Belt, he probably just keeps walking down, and then you also would have to walk into unknown where the Lilia could be or whatever. So
yeah.
And then, like, another thing is just the way you go for this. You need to walk. Like, okay, you would have been spotted by Ward here anyways. But I'm also pretty sure I've told you this before. Like, if you want to commit, like, never, like, genuinely never go through here. Always go here to dodge vision.
Yeah.
Like, if it was worded, you would have been spotted because the crab just walked you. But, like, generally just, these ganks never work. And, like, the other thing is not just dodging vision, but also just being behind them. You know, you want to be behind the enemy when you're ganking them. You want to cut off their way. Like, Echo is so good at that, especially with the W, if he plays it well. Like, these kind of steps here, I mean, at least you realize kind of quickly that it's just going to be a waste of time. Maybe you could have walked...
I saw his health, and I thought that, mm-hmm. as well as Yone's health, I could see there's a little bit of a difference.
Nah, but I think there's, like, of course, if you're in a 2v1, this little bit of a difference doesn't matter. I think, actually, if you had been a little bit more patient and actually walked here and stood for, like, 5 seconds, maybe... You could have maybe ganked because, like, the way he reacts in a second, right? It's of course, hindsight, you know, it's much easier to say in hindsight, but... Like, maybe you also thought that he saw you because of the emote or something. But,
yeah.
Like, if you actually kept looking here. Like, yeah, if you had stayed here, you could have probably punished him. Like, with this HP, you just... See, imagine you're here, you place your W somewhere here. And then, like, especially if the Yone manages to hit a knockup in your W, then it's 100% a kill. Yone also has Ignite. Oh, that's fine. And where are you going now? You're going to invade?
I was going to, and then I saw Lilia, so...
So you just waste the time, basically. Which, I think, in general, going for these invades is fine, but, like, this was not really a good timing for it. And, like, okay, I guess you could have just engaged on her here, honestly.
I was thinking, like, what items does she have? And then I realized I should have,
you have more.
Just gone in. Cause...
Yeah. You have more, and not just that, she's also at, like, 60% HP or something, right? Or 75. So,
yep.
Just place a W here. You don't need to necessarily kill her, but just, like, zone her away. And then also, I think your mid has pressure as well, especially now. Yone is level 6, Yasuo isn't. So, like,
yeah.
This could have been a good way to really crush the Lilia, you know? Like, killing her here especially... Also, you know that she doesn't have flash, right? You don't either. You should have flash. Like, if you have flash now, I think 100% go in and try to kill her. But yeah, I definitely could have done something here. Like, I still could, you know? Like, you could still just take this. She didn't even ward you. Like, she wouldn't even know. She basically gave this up, you know? So it was just like, both of you were too scared. You know? Like, you probably could have punished her here.
Yeah.
No, not probably. Like, let me say, like, you could have punished her.
I think I probably most likely could have.
Yeah, 100%. This guy's disrespecting, you know? Like, you can punish him here as well. He doesn't even have W. See, like, you need to have better awareness of your range in these situations. Like, look, just keep walking here. In a second, he will turn around, and that's when you could have engaged. See, like, now. If you hadn't done this step back, and instead stepped one more step forward, like, look, this is EQ range, 100%. Like, this is almost EQ range already. And then if you do EQ and the Yone, like, sure, I wouldn't trust the Silver Yone too much, but, like, maybe even him, maybe he would even manage to ult then.
He said to me that he doesn't even play Yone.
Okay, I mean, he has to do is, like, press his R button. Of course, yeah. The Yasuo can always flash, but, like, you probably get his flash here if you just EQ now, like...
Yeah.
Punish these kind of disrespects. Because understand also that, sure, you might not kill him, but this guy is also not going to kill you, you know? And even just chunking him down a little bit is... like, just put yourself more into the opposition's head, you know? Imagine you're this Yasuo and the enemy jungle just chunks you down to, like, 30%, let's say. That's a very realistic amount, I would say, where you can chunk him down. Like, and then he's in lane with, like, 30% HP against the Yone that's level... That's, like, a little bit XP up, and then also has Ignite and everything up. So it's, like, so horrible. And it really is not a commitment for you, you know? To just EQ. And this guy's even BMing, so it would even feel good to punish him for this. And now you're going back here when, like... It's fine, but, like, at this point, if the Lilia would have worded this correctly, she could have actually just invaded you here, you know? Like, I don't know why she put this ward. That was just really random by her. If she had just warded here, or, like, even here... she would have seen this, and then if she could have easily made the decision to just go here, and then the invade would have basically been equal. So like, you're very focused on clearing this, when in the whole time, you could have just cleared this, and it would have had more gold generated, and also made these camps respawn, right? That's the important stuff. I'm sure I've also told you before, it's just like, making camps respawn, you really need to. And like, there's a lot of time that you basically just wasted here. And this kind of wasted time, it also makes you miss out on opportunities that may arise, you know?
Yeah, because I tried to get Yasuo here.
Yeah, see, imagine you had just cleared this, and then you would have maybe had some time left over to be around mid already, you know? Or like, maybe go bot. Like, because you just had to clear now, or like, decided to clear now, it's just like, you're too late here, I guess. See, and this is, you need to realize, like, as soon as you are not able to proc your passive in these kind of fights, you just misplayed something, basically. So, what you need to do here, like, first of all, this guy, I'm pretty sure he could just keep running and nothing would be happening anyways. But he did ego you again, so he did actually stay in your W here. So, in this situation, don't either, like, throw out your Q and then, like, make sure you actually proc your passive, but I think you can't, right? I actually think you can't in the early game against Yasuo. Exactly what happens, right? He just dashes through you and then he's out of range. So in these scenarios, like, really hold your Q. Like, just hold it. Place your W, E on him. Like, there's no pressure for you to throw the Q out now. Instead, E on him, auto attack him, get his windshield out anyways. Let him dash through you and then throw the Q here. And then it will slow him, you'll be able to catch up on him. And then maybe you even kill him. Like, I'm not 100% sure if you do, because he's still kind of healthy and he's up 2 levels, but... Right, like this, you're just not able to proc your most important spell, the passive, and that's why you're just nothing is really happening. He even gifts you a Dark Harvest deck, which you really didn't have to. Yeah, now, you're just going to your top side, which I think at this point you probably should just recall. Well, I'm not sure, like, it's just kind of awkward, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know if you should have gotten something done here. I'm really not. I'm not sure if you could have killed him. Maybe you could have. But like, of course, the consistent play would have been to just like clear this and then recall, or maybe look bot. But you're just not doing very well tempo wise here, you know.
Yeah, I understand.
And this is like what you really don't want to do, right? Clearing this one camp and then like, unless there's a really good opportunity, I guess going for top now. Could salvage this. Imagine. Oh, okay, you got the kill. Good. Also, help your laner shove here. Like, help the Volibear. Just throw a Q here. Don't last hit the minions, but throw a Q and then probably just recall at this point. You really need to spend your gold. You're kind of weak on the map. Like, at this point, you're not going to be able to fight anyone really, because even the Lilia has more gold spent at least. Even though she's 1k gold down, she just has more items in her inventory, basically.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, getting the Herald here is fine. Man, like, the thing is, like, in this elo, so many things are not working the way they should be working. You know, like, in higher elos, this kind of Herald, it might be way more contested. But in general, of course, it's good if you get the... If you get it, it's a nice bonus.
My feature has, like, just went off just a second. I've gone back.
Oh, it's still on though. Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just saying, right? Like, getting the Herald here is fine. I mean, the top is dead. I guess, do we have info on Yasuo? Well, he's bot anyways. Like, I don't know if we. I don't think we saw that he's moving bot, but he is. So, this is basically a free Herald. I think just somewhere in here was a missing base, you know? Like, you would rather be on the map right now with more gold spent, in my opinion, at least. I think that's definitely correct, you know? Like, I'm a little bit unsure about a lot of this stuff, a lot of the things that I have had in my mind, because yesterday I had such a mindset shift to a lot of jungling things, but I'm more than certain that you had to spend your gold somewhere around here, like, somewhere, let's say, after you got this, you went for the invade. Like, first of all, killer here. If you kill her, you can just recall right away, get the blasting wand, you know, you have the gold. That would have been probably the best thing. And now, like, just taking this, maybe even taking the Crux as well, Or just getting the kill in mid. Like, I think kill in mid would have also been very possible here. Again, like, I didn't even say this last time, but, like, again, just walk from here. Like, why are you giving him more time to react to you, you know? Like, just come from out of vision here and, like, already be behind him. Or, like, this is just so much more distance that you need to close now, you know? So, yeah, I mean, you got the camp. I think, honestly, like, at this point, yeah, and you, I'm more than certain you just didn't look top again. Because if you see this, and just, like, go for the Crux invade as well, you know? If you see this earlier, then maybe even go for the top gank. And, like, this is what I meant with the 12 camps, because taking this one camp away, cool. Like, it's a slight positive. Taking two camps away is like, massive, honestly. Especially in the early game, it's so massive taking two camps away. Because this guy will still be stuck at level 4, you know? And you're already ahead on her. So that would have been like... And then you probably... Yeah, and see, imagine one more camp, 850, perfect recall. You just go to your bot set. You don't spend so much time walking around the map, you know? Just like... I think a big thing for you as well is just like the really try to minimize the time you spend walking around the map. If you're here, you don't want to walk to your jungle. You will like basically always recall unless you genuinely don't have... any gold to spend, you know? So, like, just being here and like, so much time you need to save by just recalling more efficiently, or you could save. Yeah, and, like, now is where you had to recall. Yeah, like, after this happened, instead of going back to jungle with your, like, kind of low HP, okay, sure, you will heal up a little bit, but, like, just now is where you need to recall, and then you probably can still punish the Olaf with extra items, you know?
Yeah.
So this is definitely, you don't want to clear these higher level camps. Like, look, you're lower level than the wolf. So that's like a good sign, I think, that you don't want to clear it. And that you would rather spend your gold first. You could have just bought the, a blasting wound here. True, you got the kill, but again, this is like just because the Olaf was trolling. You know? Like, an Olaf that's a little bit better, he would not just keep pushing when he's already hard losing the lane. You know, he wouldn't, no decent or like half decent Olaf would keep playing like this. Sure, he kind of beats him up actually, but well, in the end, he really doesn't, because Volibear's kid is kind of similar to Olaf in a way where he heals up a lot when fighting.
Yeah.
So it's like, this guy just made a massive mistake. You kind of got rewarded for staying on the map, but it was still not the correct play. Like, it really wasn't. Yeah, and now you just give so much unspent gold. Like, at this point, this might even be the correct play, but it's the plays before were not correct. So at this point, like, I guess you're probably, how much gold are you missing? I think it's 2,700 something at this point for Rocket Belt. So man, you stay on the map way too long. Like, really recall. The recalling is what's gonna help you snowball the games. And also, I don't ult you. Like, you're not dead from the tower shot. Why are you wasting your almost 2 minute cooldown?
I think I was it was a misclick.
No way. Like, how is it a misclick when you have to put in two points? Like, it's fine, like, we make mistakes, I'm just saying it's a mistake. You don't need to ult here. You're like, it looked a little bit scary maybe, but it was definitely the tower doesn't deal that much damage, you know? Like, it doesn't get you from half HP, and you were just one step away from being out of tower range.
Yeah.
At this point, you really, really, really need to recall. Man, like, look, you basically never want to stay on the map for longer than, like, 2,000 gold. And that's, like, a general guideline, a very general guideline. That especially in the early game, you need to spend your gold. Like, in the early game, you don't want to stay on the map for longer than, like, 1,000 something. Like, the breakpoints for getting, like, a blasting wand or a blasting wand plus amtrum or this kind of gold, you know? Like, you really need that tempo, because sure, like, in this game, you luckily you got kind of rewarded for staying, or like, you got away with it, but like, trust me, and that's why of course you also lose a lot of games, right? Because you maybe not don't take these bases, and then people don't make these massive mistakes, and you just are way too weak on the map. And like, also, for example, with these items, you really don't want to take Drake, right? You want to spend your gold. Like, you get it at some point, I guess. Nah, like, that's such a... So many times where you should have based already. And then also just... Yeah, okay, now you're taking the base, but, like, before that you walked around for, like, 20 seconds for no reason. And like now I understand you're incredibly strong. You could probably even go here straight away, like go towards spot and then look to contest your bot side if you have good awareness of it being up.
Yeah.
Okay, then general thing, always start at the blue here, you know, for better sequencing. At this point, it matters even less, you know, because of course you clear the camps faster, but still, there's no real downside to clearing the blue first. You have punished him here. Stole that. See, and like here you do it, right? Here you do sequence, actually. Now, why are you not taking the red? Where do you need to be? Why do you feel so pressured to be anywhere here?
I think I just wanted to take the Drake. I think that's what happened.
See, but why would you not want to take the Drake after getting the red, you know? And like being stronger for fighting as well. Like, really, get the red. It's going to help you with fighting anyways. And then also, it's not like they're on the Drake right now, you know? So you really are not pressured. And then also, another thing, like, just generally, you want your lanes to be pushed first anyways. So your laners, like, both mid and bot are both in the, like, process, like, bot is in the process of pushing, and then mid is actually kind of getting pushed in. So, like, you have more than enough time to just do the red here. Right? And this is another one of those small inefficiencies. Like, these decisions, they do add up a lot. Like, they really do. Like, sure, it's good to get the red, but you would have gotten it afterwards as well. And now you also, like, imagine you just had the red. If you had had the red already, you could be looking to make something happen, you know? Like, go into their jungle or whatever, dive them if they're under the tower. And now you kind of need to go back to the red to get it. So, yeah, I mean, you do make something happen, but you could have done that with the red buff with you, and then maybe even have a higher chance of killing them. Then again, I think at this point already you should be thinking about basing soon. Especially because Herald is coming up. So yeah, this is good. And now you should base. Maybe shove in the wave as well. Yeah, you were definitely, like, the fact that you lost this game is definitely on you, because you had such a good, like, you had a 500 gold shot, and that basically means game's for sure in your hands. And then, see, like, imagine you just don't walk around here with half your... Also, there's so many reasons, like, understand that there's so many reasons to recall here. Reason one, you're low HP, you know, you can't even make that much happen. Sure, you have red buff, you will maybe heal from your camps, so it's not the biggest reason, but that's reason number one. Reason number two, you actually have gold to spend, like, understand the Merc's power spike, not the Merc's, the Sorc's power spike is actually really big. I underestimated this for a long time, but it is actually really big. So you could have bought that, plus could have bought an 850, I don't know, not quite, but like, you could have bought an Amptom, I guess. It's like, that's a very solid base, it really is. And then, like, third reason, biggest probably even, is that you want to be at Herald, but you want to be there with your extra items, right? You want to be as strong as possible when you're there. So, like, again, you're just wasting time by walking around endlessly, basically. Sure, like, yes, because the Volibear made something happen that probably shouldn't have happened. Right? He killed the Lilia randomly in her jungle. So, like, yes, because of that, you could actually invade, but normally this is not really a timing to invade, especially not with your HP. You know, you're like, okay, you kind of got some HP back and whatever, but really, you would much rather just have spent your gold here and then been at Herald with full gold spent. Ah, she actually died to the minion, lol. Okay, that's good that you ulted there. That's like a big thing here. You didn't proc your passive. Prioritize procing your passive there, and then you get away from the Olaf. And then also, not just in that situation in the entry, but also here, like, prioritize procing your passive. It doesn't matter if, like, the Olaf is a little bit tankier, maybe, but you really just need to think more about procing this passive for yourself, you know? You need that movement speed. You need that movement speed in these situations to just be able to run down a little bit and wait for your cooldowns to come up. You know, because if you don't have extra movement speed, they can just keep chasing, especially champs like Olaf, they have a lower on their Q and whatever. You really need that movement speed. And you already had one stack on the Olaf, and then with the E you decided to attack the Yasuo, you know? You need to decide to attack the Olaf here. And especially because also the Volibear is fighting him, I'm pretty sure, yeah. So you want to kill him. Like, you probably wouldn't have killed him. And then here, he flashed away in a second. Now you have the rocket, the Q up. And he still has the two passive stacks for another, like, second, I guess. So really, while you're running away, especially, like, proc your passive here. Super, super important. I assume you die because you didn't, right?
Yeah.
See, because now you would have to go back into proc it. And, like, in this situation also, like, yes, you fucked up before already, so that was, of course, not good. Like, the big thing here really is just not proccing the passive. Like, that would have 100% saved you, and probably also, this was probably a pretty decisive moment in the game, right? Because you gave a big shutdown, and overall the game is pretty even. So, definitely, like, I'm sure you didn't lose the game, really. We can see in the time that you had some good moments as well, but still, like, this definitely, if you hadn't given your shutdown here, you would have still been, like, completely in control, basically. But giving that shutdown is definitely a big problem. Also, like, this Olaf, was he not 0-3? How was he... How did he, like, catch up so much and they even get ahead in CS? Damn. But what I was saying, like, now you still have the empowered E auto attack. So, like, at this point, just proc your passive at least, you know? Maybe if they don't react quickly enough, you might even get away somehow because this is, like, low elo. But even if not, then you at least dealt the maximum amount of damage you could have dealt, you know? Like, there's no reason for you to just keep dying without proccing the passive. It's definitely gonna get this guy to kind of low HP.
Understood.
Okay, and then you go back because you see something happening here.
Yeah.
You don't really want to go there though, right? Because, like, it's just, I guess, bad foresight from you, from what's gonna happen here. Let's see, like, let's see if we see this, like, at what point do you make the decision to go there? Like, now. I think, okay. It's honestly generally fine to make that decision because this fight could have definitely taken a little bit longer, for sure. Like, I don't think it's a massive mistake, but definitely ping more, I guess. Ping more that you're on your way. I mean, you pinged a bunch of times beforehand. Now, when do you ping? Okay, I mean, you ping now. I guess you kept pinging and she just didn't really keep them in the fight. So it's like not the worst thing in the world to just be down here. At least you could get the crab now, which you definitely should.
I think I...
No, again, instead of going for the very, like, not even... I mean, it's not 100% guaranteed because the bot lane has, like, numbers advantage and whatever, but you go for so many low percentage plays, you know? Like, really think... This is what I, also another thing of, like, active thinking, like, really... actively think before going for a play, like, what is, like, genuinely put a number on it, like, put a number, what's the percent of this working? What, 10% maybe? Maybe if this guy starts completely trolling and running in your face and then, like, he's still full HP, you probably don't even have info on his flash. He will have it up in 30 seconds, so he is actually flashless here, but, like, especially if he had flash, like, you never kill a full HP Yasuo like this. You just don't.
Okay.
And then if you want to go for something here, then like, do it faster at least, you know? Like, while you see him stepping in here, place a W in here and go over, proc your passive, and then, like, chunk him down or something. You never kill him here anyway, so you really don't. But, like, while you see him walking in here, like, place your W, see if something is happening at least. But instead of doing that, what you should have just done is, like, first of all, get the crap first. Get crap even before the Raptors, and then just go back through your camps here. And the whole time, like... The skill of jungling is just having really good awareness, and that's why you should be looking at the minimap so much. And then just constantly seeing, like, basically after every camp seeing, is there an opportunity arising somewhere? Like, the better you are at the game, the more experience, the more you will be able to see into the future, you know? Like, maybe sometimes you will see situations where people are, like, genuinely full HP and you still have the feeling that the way this lane or this matchup might play out, you can go there. But, like, generally, for you, I think the big thing is really just, like, taking these looks, first of all, like, in general, like, just actually taking a look at the lane, and then most of the time, the choice is going to be obvious, you know? If there's a really low HP target and they're overextending, then just go there. And, like, it happens in every single game in your Elo, right? Already happened so much, especially with the Olaf in the early, when you were here, he was on like 1 HP, could have punished that like for probably a whole minute. And then just like, you know, and instead you choose to make these kind of plays where it's like you need your Yone to play correctly, you need him to bait anyways. And then like, let's see how this plays out even. And then, why are you ult?
I don't know. Full HP. I don't know what happened there. I think,
maybe this was a misclick.
Yeah, that was a misclick.
Okay, general thing. There's some champions in this game where you don't want to EQ combo unless you're, like, more than certain that you can hit it, you know? Like, unless they have used their cooldowns, basically. Because there are cooldowns in the game. Let's say Yasuo W, Samira W. They make your Q disappear. So, like, against these champs, and, like, against other champs, let's say, like, for example, Vayne is a champ that you don't often want to EQ because you would rather E on her, wait for her to push you away with the E, and then slow her with the Q, you know, so you can still reach her. So there's a bunch of these champs where you really just don't want to EQ combo them most of the time because you would rather have your Q after they used, like, their spells. And not even, it's, for Yasuo, it's not even just the W, it's also the E, you know. Because usually when you will jump on him, he will just E through you and then he'll be out of range. So you need to have your Q up for that. So this is like a big, big reason why this didn't work out, right? Just next time, just E over, out attack him. He's not going to stay in your W here. If you had placed a little bit better, maybe something happened or something would have been able to happen. But like, yeah, I mean, especially the ult was, of course, not good. I'm sure you already knew that. Like, if you have your ult at least here, you can maybe fight still. But of course, right, you're just missing both instances of your Q. It's a super important spell to be able to proc your passive, and that's why you're not procing your passive. Imagine you had just E'd on him here, waited for him to do his dashing, and then Q'd him, right? Slowed him, maybe helped your Yone also in being able to hit his knockup. It's like, this is a big thing, and when I'm playing bad, I also don't play with this enough, but like, I think holding your Q is often not a bad choice. It really isn't, like, just having the patience to hold your Q and, like, sure, when you're actually in a position to one-shot people and whatever, that then you want to do the EQ combo, or like, when you're chasing, yes, you need to do the EQ combo to get in range, but in these situations where you already are in range, it's often better to just hold your Q and then, like, just prioritize or, like, make sure that you're able to proc your passive, because that's obviously the big thing missing here. Then you also get hit by the Yasuo knockout and he's just dashing through you and basically playing you. And the whole time, right, for this you also lost crap. You already could have generated basically a gold worth of kill. Probably could have been level 11 as well. So you just chose to go for a really low percentage play, and it went horribly wrong, right? And that's why you kind of lost control of this game. For, like, because this is low elo, there's always opportunities, and we can see that in the timeline, right? You get a bunch of kills. So like, don't give up because you made a mistake like this. Never give up anyways, but still, just understand that these are the kind of mistakes you just need to cut out. Okay, even got the Drake here.
I think I'll die again.
Probably die because you don't have ult.
Yep.
Yeah. Let's see.
But at the same time, I think we got turret as well.
Yeah, this definitely was kind of positive for you, but again, W, like, where's your W? Why would you not press your W when you're going into, like, literally four people here and looking to steal? There's no reason, like, this is a big thing, and I don't know what exactly is your mental blockade with that, but, like, because you even told me, right, that's something I've told you before, and it's clearly something that you still don't do. It's just, like, it's really just one button press. So, like, when we go into a live game in a second, I really want you, like, that should be your main focus. Like, using W in genuinely every single fight. There's no reason not to. Like, sure, there's, of course, maybe better or worse times to use it, but it's always better to use it somehow than not using it at all. And, of course, also just using it. Like, imagine you, like, even now, even if you would have used it a little bit too late here, right? Like, of course, the point where you really need to use it is before even going in here. But, like, even after, like, now, even placing it now would be good, you know? Placing it somewhere here now where you want to escape, it will probably still save you. You're so much more ready. I've noticed you're so much more ready to use big cooldowns than, like, your normal cooldowns. Like, you use your rocket build here to get away, you use your flash here early to just, like, get a kill that you would have gotten anyways. When you could just be, like, using your normal cooldowns and you wouldn't have to use any of these big cooldowns, and then you would have them up for, like, more opportunities, right?
Yeah.
Like, you're missing out on opportunities because you're using your flash in bad ways, you're using your rocket belt too easily, you're maybe using your ult sometimes also randomly like this. I mean, there's already, like, 18 minutes and you already wasted two ults, basically, right? This one was wasted and then this one was even more wasted. So, it's another thing for sure, like, this is, again, why I'm saying, like, with this active thinking, because a lot of these mistakes just give me the, like, picture that you are not really actively thinking before you're using abilities, you're just using them, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, that's not an insult or anything, it's just how it is, and, like, oftentimes when you're, like, kind of on autopilot or whatever, it's just, you're kind of not really thinking, you're just playing the game, and, like, most people in your ELO, they probably just play like that, right? Like, they, and when I used to mean, like, I played like that as well, but obviously you have these coaching sessions, so you obviously want to improve, right? So that's definitely a big thing you need to just start doing more. I'm sure there are situations where you do actively think about what's going on, but clearly there's also a lot of situations where you don't really, so, like, or you, like, because I don't think you're stupid or anything, and you can't, like, if you actively think about a lot of these situations, I'm sure you would come to the right conclusion yourself, you know? But just in-game, you're not really... Well, you're just... It seems like you're not actively even thinking about if it's a right or a wrong play. You're just making plays, and then if it doesn't work out, you just get punished for it quite hard. Here, I don't know, you have, like, zero awareness. I feel like you could wanna, like... I shouldn't even say, I feel like you could just be doing something here. Like, you could just be placing your W over here, going over. Then I don't know why you even threw that Q. But at this point, it's not the end of the world. Your Q cooldown is not very long, but... It's like, W over here. This is a situation, for example, where I think you want to EQ the Yasuo, because he is in kill range, especially if you had Rocket Belt. But, like... And also, buy the boots before. I didn't look at the items too much, but, like, but maybe I told you the wrong thing some time ago, but definitely, like, Sorcs are really, really good. Like, I've underestimated, but Sorcs are really, really good. Even for Echo, even though he has very good AP scalings, like, the flat magic pen, especially early, like, it makes, and not just that, of course, also the movement speed. You know, especially in this game, everyone has tier 2 boots except for you. Like, genuinely everyone. So you're just gonna be left behind in a lot of these fights, right? You're not going to be able to chase people down the way you want them to, want to chase them down, maybe. Like, sure, you're still Echo if you manage to proc your passive, you are able to do that, but you just need to match their movement speed anyways. And that's also why I've actually started building sword boots even before rocket belt sometimes, when my gold is kind of awkward and I can't buy anything else. And it doesn't, because I saw Echo the Nico do it, and it really doesn't feel bad. Like, it actually doesn't. It's a very solid power spike, and especially when you're a little bit ahead early, it just allows you to be even more oppressive, you know, because people can't get away from you as easily. It's actually something I have not thought about too much before, but it's really, it makes a big difference. And then here, I don't know, like, you really had no awareness of this fight happening, it felt like, I don't know why. Like, you, I don't know if you were mad at your team or something, but... It's like you actively made the choice to just not help them, you know? Like, you could have easily helped them here. So 3v2, they already used a bunch of their spells, right? No Nautilus hook, no E, no ult. Yasuo is in the middle of engaging on them. So if you just W over here, EQ, like, you don't have your Q, but, like, even W over here, maybe you can even hit the return Q. Nah, probably not. It's too late for that. But, like, you have ult up and everything. There's no reason for you to not play the game here. Like, taking this camp... It's definitely trolling. We used your W here. Yeah, just generally, like, this W is not good. Like, you're not in the head of the Yasuo here. He sees you placing the W. So, why are you placing it exactly where he stands? Like, do you think he's actually gonna keep standing? Or, like... Even towards you, like, why would you run at you with, like, half HP here? Place it here. Like, place the W here. It's so much more likely to get something done. And it just cuts off their way, you know? It's like really think of the W as some kind of wall, maybe, if that helps you. Like, it really is that powerful, generally. You might not get a stun 100%, but you will at least get the slow here. And like the fact that this Nautilus was stunned is literally only because he's silver, you know? He wouldn't should never get stunned there. And that, then you should have genuinely died here as well, I think. This could have turned out so much better. Like, you should have died here. If this Nautilus is not an idiot, he just waits until you're actually, like, sleeping, and then he hooks you, you know, and he hits it 100%. So, like, and then, like, I mean, maybe nobody could have followed up, maybe you would have been able to live with ult, but... So, like, you should not have gotten off here as easily. And then here, like, throw in a Q. Okay, that's kind of what you're doing, you sadly miss it. It happens, like, this is not what we need to focus on, you missing Qs or whatever, that happens, like... It's not a big deal. The important thing is that you actually threw it, and that's, like, correct, I guess. Just, like, maybe you took, like, one step too much into them, though. Really, just, like, use your range here. There's no need to be closer to them than like, your Q range is. It's, like, now just throw the Q already, basically. Or, like, one more step. Now throw it, and you probably would have hit all of them. It just took a little bit too long. Then... W before ulting W here, before ulting, yeah, that's again big thing missing. Yeah, imagine you had the shield here, you literally get a quadra kill. Now, this fight is still positive for you, I guess, because I think your team kind of cleans it up, but could have turned out so much better.
Yeah.
Do you look at the cooldowns a lot while you're fighting?
Not really.
Start doing that more. Like, sure, you've played a lot of Echo games, so you probably have some amount of feeling, but clearly your feeling is not good enough. Because like there's so many fights where you could just be using your spells 1 or 2 seconds quicker, and it just makes such a difference, you know? Like, yeah. If you had placed your W on top of yourself here, then ulted, you would have 100% proc'd it, probably even got some of them stunned. It probably would have been able to proc passive and then just, like, harvest one of them after the other, basically. And, like, this fight turns out 10 times better. It's, like, just, again, W completely missing. See, like, the Nautilus here, he still had 2 stacks on him. The Kai'Sa still had 2 stacks on her. Like, if you just had that extra little bit of durability here and then also stunned them, probably, this would have been, like, such a massive ult from you. But, like, this, it was just kind of... It was still good. Of course, you got them low, but... Yeah, they should have literally... All of them should have died, and you probably would have even been the one getting the kills. Like, you're still actually the second strongest person in this game, gold-wise. So, like, you're still very much in a position to play this game. And especially if you're in these kind of positions, you should be kind of happy, because you're stronger than the Lilia, even though she has a 400 gold shutdown. So, it should just be, like, a very easy way for you to get back into this game. And then also, like, in the past, maybe I would have also bought the mercs here. But, like, this nowadays, like, I don't buy mercs ever anymore, honestly.
Okay.
I think whenever I need the tenacity, I just get it in my runes, you know? And then maybe also Green Smite, if I feel like Green Smite is good, if it's like really a lot of CC. But the Sorg's value is genuinely too good to pass up on.
Understood.
Yeah, and like, it is not bad, like, the mercs really are only against the Lilia ult, you know? Like, against Lilia ult, it's good, because Lilia ult is how long? Like, 2 seconds, 2.5 on max rank, so taking away 30% of that is definitely something. But other than that, there's really no big CC that you want the... Like, it doesn't help against Nautilus CC, not really, the Tenacity, so... Yeah, like, definitely a Sorg's game. But just in general, like, nowadays for me, genuinely every game is a Sorg's game. Unless they're, like, very, very AP heavy and CC as well. Then the mercs are not bad, but... Like, unless their value is, like, way, way, way too high, then the Sorg's is generally just better. And yeah, like, at this point, you really should not be farming your own jungle too much anymore. Like, yeah, you should, like, that's what you meant probably by, like, you feel like you're just not farming enough, and that's fine, like, the farming should have happened a bit more earlier, and then, like, at this point, you're still gonna be able, if you're doing well, you're still gonna be able to have high farm numbers just by taking enemy camps, and then, like, you will still take your own jungle, but, like, mostly when you have genuine downtime, right? Like, at this point, you're or like even after getting the rocket belt, honestly, like after getting a rocket belt, your focus should already be shifting a bit more towards having impact. So like ignoring these camps and whatever is fine. I guess I personally probably would have taken the red tier. It would have given you level 12. It would have given you the red buff, of course, and you would have also been able to just smite it, so it doesn't even take a long time. But generally, it's fine that you're looking to make plays here instead of... Yeah, I don't even know what this guy's doing. Like, they're just rolling. So, nice. And now you need to get Nash. Why are you not getting Nash? Why do I not see Nash in the timeline? Still, I don't see, like... Now you need, like, you can still easily do Nash, like, ping your team to do... Why are you not doing Nash? Like, your team is so good at it as well. With Yone, with Tristana, with Echo, like, you three, you can easily do Nash. This is where you, like, genuinely lost the game. Or, like, this is where you... Like, of course, there's a lot of smaller mistakes, some also kind of big, I guess, but, like, this is a massive mistake, like, a monumental mistake. Not taking Nash, like, I don't even know why nobody, not a single person pinged it. This is why all of you guys are in silver, you know? Because, like, I understand that, like, it's literally a kill for everyone. Plus, like, extra stats you get while it's active. Plus, of course, like, towers you were probably gonna get. And, like, getting the Nash, it would just push you so much closer to victory, you know? And, like, instead you just take such a small win, you know? It was such a massive win getting them here. But instead you chose to get such a small win by, like, okay, you can clear your jungle for free because there's actually downtime. And, like, now you ping for it, but it's too late, you know? Everyone's up again, and now it also matters that you're kind of low HP. Just, like, do it right away. Like, really understand that Nash, at the moment, like, I'm always even complaining about it on stream right now, or, like, I have been complaining about it a bunch of times already. I think Nash is too weak. I think Nash needs to be stronger. Like, after 20 minutes as a jungler, you really can't show bot side and higher elos. Because people are aware of the fact that any three champs that have some amount of DPS, they can just rush Nash after 20, right when it spawns, basically. Which I think shouldn't be the case, but it's just, like, you need to have that awareness. It's such an easy objective to take. It really is. Like, now you take a bit... Where do you... And like, this is something you need to plan. You need to plan better. Like... Because your jungler is still up. You need to, like, 2.5k is such a common gold. Like, it's such a, like, I've said this so many times, like, I need 2.5, I'm looking to get 2.5k gold before I'm going base here, you know? And, like, it's kind of awkward. It is kind of awkward because Drake is spawning, but this all happened because you didn't take Nash, you know? Yeah. Take Nash here, if you would have taken Nash beforehand, you would have been, like, able to just clear these two camps, and then you had 2.5k, and you have more than enough time to get to the Drake as well. And then it's, like, perfect, and you're basically just turned the game in your favor again. So, yeah, like, not taking Nash hurt you in so many ways, because you can't really go to this jungle, right? Like, it will take you too long to get to Drake. So now you're just leaving base with 1,000 gold, which is awful. Like, this hurts. Like, you really don't want to ever leave base with this much gold.
Right.
And especially in a close game like this, right? Like, every single AP matters that you can have. I can't believe you lost this game. Like, again, you need to be doing Nash right now. Why is nobody thinking about that? Who gives a fuck if this guy gets inhib? Like, let one person base, but, like, let it not be the melee, let it not be you. The Volibear just needs to be the one basing. And see, and this is what you need to understand, that, like, okay, sure, you get him here because you have ult and he's not respecting it, but, again, like, a better Olaf, they would just be respecting your ult here as well, so they would not die like this. So, yes, because it's a 2v1, you can kind of play like this, but generally, you should not be playing like this. You should just be playing with your cooldowns. Like, don't let him beat you up so much, because that's the only way he's also gonna heal, you know? Like, at least make him run for you, or, like, make him run at you. There's so many big macro decisions that are just, like... This is the second time where you could have done Nash in literally, like, 3 minutes, and you just didn't. Like, I'm sure every single person in this game knows how good Nash is. Like, even Silver players know how good of an objective Nash is. I don't know... But I've noticed this before, where like people just don't do it. And then also here, like just rocket belt him. You don't need to chase him for such a long time. Place W again. Also like this game, you literally played like the no W challenge or something. As soon as you see this guy, especially now, he queued in. Place your W behind him. Place where he's gonna walk. Such an easy, like,
yeah.
This is not rocket science, you know? Like, sure, there's some Ws that are, like, genuinely impressive. Maybe you have, like, a really good read, but, like, these kind of Ws, especially for you, you have 1 million points of accuracy, you've played him a lot. They should be, like, such... It should literally be muscle memory to just place the W behind him here. And, like, because that's where he's gonna walk, and if he's not gonna walk here, then he has to walk here, and then you'll have a much easier time catching up to him. And, like, this guy just needs to die instantly. And then, like, okay, and this is not something I'll highlight too much, but, like, a small optimization here. Since you already walked into his melee range, just, like, auto-attack him and then Q. It's just kind of...
Okay.
Right? Then he was already in auto-attack range, so he would already have two stacks, and then you can just proc passive right away. And that's also... I guess tanky targets, like, Nautilus, you want to proc it as early as possible, just so the cooldown starts even, you know?
Okay.
And then, yeah, like, big thing missing W. Imagine you had placed your W, you would have even stunned the Yasuo. And then you would have saved your Yon with that as well. Whole time, like, you're literally not placing your W anywhere. Like, yeah, at this point it's a little bit more awkward, but... You could have just placed it anywhere. Really. You could have even... Like, that's obviously awkward that you were, like, knocked up here, but like, just E over this wall. Why are you E-ing here? I actually don't understand. Why would you make the decision to E into their base when you...
Panic.
Yeah, okay, no. Happens, I guess. That's like a good explanation, right? But, like, could have easily just, like, E'd over here. Sure, you might not know if anyone's there, but even then you would still rather be here, because here you're gonna be fucked no matter what. Like, there's no real good way out here without ult, without flash. And like just imagine you could have literally had the Nash already. I think we probably should just be going into a live game, otherwise it will be taking too long. But like I'm sure there was already so much here, right? Like, yeah, you still get some kills, we can take a look at that if you want. Probably you could have taken Nash after that as well. No, okay, Nash was down here. Yeah, let me just see why you didn't end after that, I guess. Because at this point the depth cameras are really long, right, and they're their deaths are kind of clumped together, so... Okay, you kill him. No, okay, they're kind of not clumped together, I guess they're exactly like one after the other. Go for end now. Like, why are you... Okay, you don't have minions, never mind. If you had minions, definitely go for end here. Don't even have the tier 1 tower top, that's crazy. I mean, this is where you need to go for end. Yeah, place your W here. Okay, that's fine where you place your W. How did you lose this game?
That's what I'm thinking.
Why are you not stepping into your W? You're literally so quick and you're 1 centimeter away from it. Like, you could have ulted anyways, but you didn't even have to, you know? Like, just, why would you not step into you? Okay, the minions block you a little bit, but if they're actually blocking you, then just, you need to be quick enough to ult. Like, that's why you didn't end, right? Because you just died here for no real reason.
Yeah,
so,
and then they just
okay, let me just, but okay, you got the Nash as well, so why did you not end after that? Or like, with that? Okay, kind of missed your ult. Happens. Just like, again, W was just nowhere to be found, you know?
Yeah,
so, just imagine, like, place your W here somewhere. At this point, you know, like, you have 2,500 HP. You can literally add like 33% of that, even more. Like, you can add another 1,500 that you can just tank here and then maybe even stun them. Maybe, and that probably allows you to proc passive or something, you know? Like, all of this stuff, it adds up. Like, all of these W's not being used, it really just adds up to you not being able to proc passive, not killing people, and this kind of stuff. Like, this is genuinely like your biggest thing. And it's, I think the reason why it might be so difficult for you is just because you have played so much Ekko, but you have played him so wrong for a long time, you know? So it's just like very deeply ingrained in your gameplay, the fact to not, but like, that's why you need to just actively break it. And I think, yeah, like at this point, I mean, you know, okay, you killed them again here though, why did you? Okay, I mean, at this point they got all the inip, so now you can't just end as easily. Honestly, with Ekko, Ekko is very good at backdooring. It's for sure an angle here. Like, look if you can get a backdoor opportunity. The Nexus is open, you know? Like, look if you can maybe sneak in here.
That's what I was trying to do. I think I was trying to do that, but I ended up dying in the process.
I mean, definitely, yeah, just wait until they're pushing somewhere. Well, yeah. I mean, if you're ever backdooring, like, why would you, like, go through the jungle, you know? Honestly, like, this game, I think you could have won on your own. If you just, like, walk here, walk into the jungle, of course, like, you need to sweep and whatever you need to make. You don't even have a sweeper. Jesus. Like, at 40 minutes, you need to have a sweeper. Like, you should get it. I think you should get it after, like, your first or maybe second base. Depending on how likely, I guess the more likely it is that the enemy invades you, the better it is to keep the wards. So, in this game, Lilia is not going to invade you, not really. So just, like, get the sweeper. She also doesn't have sweeper, that's crazy. Like, only, as a jungler, you really need it. You need to know if you're being spotted when you're going for invades and this kind of stuff. Or, like, when you're going for ganks, just, like, imagine how much less time you waste if you just get the sweeper and you know that you're being spotted. And not just that, like, also, if you're being spotted somewhere and you're, like, kind of out of position, you might even get collapsed or whatever. So it's so important. And, like, at this point, how are you ever gonna successfully go for a backdoor if you don't even know if you're being spotted on the way there, you know? But in general, if you're going to backdoor, like, you told me that's what you were looking to do, but, like, clearly, I mean, maybe later, but, like, clearly not here, because why would you be going mid for that?
I think we lost the game.
So, you could have easily won this game on your own. Like, no joke. At this point, just stay somewhere here, because we have full vision of them anyways. We see that all of them are pushing, and they won't think about you, not really. Just, like, stay somewhere here, wait until they're, like, too deep, and then wait on the perfect opportunity is to wait until they start fighting, you know? Because then they also can't recall. And, like, at this point, you clear the stuff so fast, you know? You have the Lich Pin, you have Nashus as well. Like, you will clear the inhib in, like, 5 auto-attacks or 3 auto-attacks or something. And then, like, until they recall and whatever, even if they do recall, you can still get so much time with Ekko, you know? Like, with the W, with the ult. Like, you would have... I'm sure, like, if you had put me in this game in, like, 3 minutes earlier, I would have backdoored this 100%. See, they're all just running down here. Nobody's checking the sides or whatever. Of course, now they also killed you, but still, like, they wouldn't have. I'm more than certain. Like, Ekko is very good at backdooring. So yeah, like, so many, like, genuinely probably, like, 5 big opportunities missed in this game where you could have just ended. Like, very easy and obvious opportunities as well. So yeah, I think I will try to give you a lot of active advice during this game. But of course, like, the big thing I'm already gonna tell you is to, like, use your W. Like, really focus on using your W. I don't want to overwhelm you. I think, like, the big thing, just, like, the one thing you really need to worry about is using your W. And then I'll try to give you some active advice during the game.
Understood. Can you see my screen?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What are you currently banning, by the way?
To be honest, I don't know who to ban, because Kha'Zix, actually, I think I've been banning Kha'Zix, because actually even he's been nerfed, so I haven't...
He has been, but in lower elos he still has a very good win rate, so I think it's definitely a fine ban, honestly. Like, in higher elos, the nerfs seem to have mattered because people are better at punishing, I guess, if he's just not as overpowered, but in low elo he still has, like, a very good win rate, so...
Right.
Sure, fine. How is your Q time so long, damn?
I don't know why that is either. Just happens sometimes.
I think, like, someone told me that the player base is, like... Actually, not that high in, like, silver and ranks below there. I think most players are in gold to
emerald. I thought the majority of players were in silver.
No, I think nowadays the majority of players are in gold, but I'm not sure.
Oh, it's probably because of the new emerald rank.
Yeah, maybe. I can't decide if the new ranking system was positive or not, honestly. It feels like master players especially are, like, it's like... The quality, or like, it's not even because of Emerald, it's more because of the fact that promos got removed, but it's like, Master feels like the new D4 in some ways. Like, obviously it's not quite as bad probably, but still. It's like, there's a lot of very weird stuff happening there. Okay, so... What do you need to focus on, I guess, since we have some time? Maybe except for the W, I'm sure you remember that.
W thing and macro decisions.
Yeah, I think that's probably the second biggest thing, yeah.
Yeah, it's making sure I go in fights when I need to go in, when I can go in, and knowing when not to go in, and also knowing when to invade and when not to invade, that kind of thing.
Yeah, I think the invading stuff is really lower priority, you know? Like, I got to Masters without ever worrying too much about that, you know? So it's like, yes, it's for sure a good thing if you invade and, like, really crush your enemy jungle, but it's not something that's at all necessary in your elo. Like, in your elo, you can...
I've experienced a lot more invades.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when I was... when I was playing in Silver, of course, I just experienced a lot more invades regardless. So, yeah.
Mm. It's not a silver thing, like, trust me, it's just random. And, like, people... And I can tell you that 99% of the invades that are happening, that they should not be... they should not go unpunished. I went back to attack speed. I think attack speed feels really good. But, for Echo, can definitely recommend it. It just feels smoother, you know? Taking attack speed in the... Small ones. Like, if you want, you can of course still play with the double adaptive, but just try it out, maybe. When's the last time you played with it?
I think it was like a month ago.
Okay. No, I mean, if you prefer it, do whatever you want. It's really... Like, there's good players with double adaptive, good players with attack speed. I played with double adaptive for a bunch, like, probably 200-300 games now, but I just went back to attack speed and it felt so much better. I don't know.
Right.
Even the kiting in the jungle and whatever, it just feels smoother. Everything feels smoother. Jesus, your team is literally picking full AP here.
Oh dear.
It's like in this elo, people sometimes they don't even build them R anyways, so...
Wait, RE support, is that a thing?
I mean, I've not seen it, but I guess it's fine, you know? She has her charm, she has some, like, poke stuff, so I'm sure it's not completely useless or anything. Definitely.
Unless the mid and the support is switching, but I don't know.
No, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I mean, it's Lux, right? Lux Caitlyn is definitely a good lane as well. But that would be random.
Oh, he's dodged.
My god. I mean, you shouldn't be too unhappy about that, honestly. Your team was very AP-heavy.
Yep.
But that's the thing also, like... If you get ahead, then you really don't care, you know? Like, you really don't. Because enemies will not be able to buy more anyways before, like... And if you manage to close out the games, then... Yeah, what I also wanted to say about, like, the macro thing is just... not only just these big macro decisions, just like always think, especially after the early game, like always think, how what can I do now to push this game closer to victory, you know? That should be like your active, like an active question you ask yourself. And like a big answer to that might be something like take Nash or whatever, right? Like then you just instantly come to that conclusion. Like especially after, like a very general thing, like after you won a team fight or whatever, always try to get something on the map. Always try to get either a tower, or like a neutral objective. And like towers have priority, you know? Because usually you take the tower and then you can fall back to the neutral objective before.
I've been trying to get a lot more towers and objectives, but
And like sometimes even do it on your own, you know? Sometimes when you feel like you're in a really good spot, but your team is like kind of trolling you the whole time, just make the choice to go on the sideline yourself, right? And like pull people there from the enemies, or if they don't come, then you just get towers and you're opening up the map for your team, and like it's. You might not feel it directly, but trust me, like it's gonna. Every single tower matters. Like they all matter for like getting closer to a victory.
Right.
So you also tried out Transcendence a little bit, right? But you just switched it back to Absolute Focus.
Yeah. Transcendence was nice. Mm-hmm. Cooldowns, but I just felt like I could finish them off much easier with the more AP, with the greater AP.
Yeah, that's fine.
My rune step is very offensive kind of game.
I think Transcendence is also offensive, but just different, I guess. I like Transcendence more for like multi-kill potential, I guess. But the absolute focus is definitely not bad either.
How do you play against the Xin Zhao?
Definitely respect him. Like that's another thing. Jeez, why are your teams like full AP for no reason? Whatever, don't worry about that too much, like, really don't. It's just so weird that they, like, actively make the choice to pick AP champs to make the game difficult for everyone.
I do hope he doesn't dodge again.
No, but, like, for Xin, it's like, respect the fact that he's level 3 or whatever, he will be stronger than you. Like, Xin is probably one of the strongest early junglers in the game. So just respect him and play against him, like... Be aware of dodging his W, of course, like when he tries to poke you, basically.
Yeah.
Like, be aware of dodging that, of course, and then, like, again, just play in a similar playstyle to how you would play against Olaf or whatever, because you don't want... Like, in a perfect world, you even manage to respect his E range, which is kind of difficult because it's point to click, but, yeah, of course, if he doesn't hit his W, his E range is not that big, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, just stay out of range, throw Qs at him, and then proc your passive on him. And, like, only fully engage on him when you actually can. But, like, mostly try to ignore him, honestly. Like, you have so many good targets in this game, like, basically everyone else. So, just try to kind of ignore him, only fight him when he's, like, when you're able to proc passive on him without him being able to fully engage on you, and then you should be fine.
If I can't proc my passive, it's because he uses his ult to run away.
Sure, but then he will also not kill you. I mean, and then he will just have used his ult. And, like, if you have managed to proc your passive before then you'll be able to chase him down.
Yeah.
And if you have your W placed somewhere where it maybe catches him. I mean, you have some very good lanes to gank here. Probably just ignore bot lane. Like, bot lane is basically ungankable. You have no CC set up there, and they have Ezreal, Morgana, which are, like, two very difficult champs to gank. But Lux, you can for sure gank if she's overextending, or they're kind of low. But definitely be aware of the barrier, though. And then top should be where you're looking mostly, because Pantheon has, like, very good point-to-click CC, and Caitlyn's also probably gonna push, you know, because it's range versus melee. And Caitlyn just wants to push, so... I think this is a game you probably should just full clear top here. Like, start at the red Crux Raptors, and then see if you can go top right away. And if not, then you just keep clearing, and then you see if you can go top. But, like, after every camp, when you're on your second side, when you're on your blue side here, after every camp, really look top and see if something changed, right, for your ability to gank there. Like, interrupt your pathing if you have to. Getting a kill is always going to be worth more. Because you will get your jungle afterwards as well, you know?
Yeah.
I think definitely cover topside. Like the river entrance on the top
Okay.
side. Where the Syndra is basically is where I meant, but it's whatever, she's covering it now. Yeah,
Okay.
just like you can place a ward there a little bit later. Also, why are you playing without Blitz? I thought you had that. Or without any jungle timers. Didn't you have jungle timers? Definitely recommend
No,
that.
because I have a
Ah, you
map,
have.
so
Ah, yeah,
I
right. Yeah, that's what that was the problem. Yeah, it's. Are you sure there's no apps that work for Mac though? I'm pretty sure
There
there
is
might
one,
be.
but it heavily affects my gameplay, so I decided to not
Okay.
use it.
It
Because it
makes it lag or something.
increases my ping by like
Yeah, okay.
300,
Oh,
and
okay.
I can't
That's
really play the
weird.
game.
Yeah, definitely. Well, it's not the end of the world, but I'm pretty sure it would help you quite a bit.
Yeah.
Just for like understanding. Okay, place your W now. Step into it when the rep buff spawns. Well, you stepped into it a little bit earlier. It's not the end of the world because at least you tanked one hit with the W shield. So it's really basically the same thing. Okay, already kite your camp down. Like already kite towards the Crux. So make sure the Teemo poison doesn't steal it. I don't think it will though. Smite the croc. And I mean, you can look bot here as well, right? Like after the Rapus, you can make the kind of like unconventional plant go bot if there's an actual opportunity. So just look there, but like here you won't go there. You won't. And in general, of course, I said this lane is not the most gankable, but if anything, it's kind of gankable early. Then here, like, definitely look mid. Really look mid. And but don't go there. Look, just look. Looking and going is not the same thing. Yeah, I mean, maybe you could have went, but now is where you need to look top. Now is where you really need to look top. I think just go there, honestly.
Isn't there like a huge wave?
Yeah,
Or
but like you will one-shot her if the Pantheon just ping that you're going there to like communicate. Look, yeah, see, place W somewhere in her path. Didn't have to
I
flash,
shouldn't have
but
flashed.
yeah, it's fine. But see, like, understand, like, this is what I mean. Like, if she was full HP, but you need to understand that Caitlyn top, there's a reason nobody plays her top, and especially if the wave state is like this, you just get her. Yeah, I think definitely could have looked mid more here again. Also, like, this guy's kind of low. And we don't know if she has barrier, though. She probably has, so. Yeah, just get blue, get crab after her.
Oh.
Oh. Make sure to smite the blue. Smite. Okay, that's fine. You will get away. In the future, like, prioritize proccing your passive here. Well. Auto attack! Would've killed him.
Oh.
Would've killed him. Again, make the best out of a kind of bad situation, and the bad situation being that you die, but like it would actually be good because you would have gotten a kill traded. But like, okay.
Can I go top again?
Yeah. Go to your Grump. I mean, the crab's probably gonna be gone. Although he might have left it because he was kind of low. Definitely check for it. Yeah, you could just go top straight away. If she like look, keep looking at the way. Why see? Like, there's no reason for the camera to be on you right now. It can be on Caitlyn the whole time while you're walking there. Okay, so you took the. So it's warded.
Oh no.
But like, understand that she's just gonna kill you. Now you're kind of fucked. I mean, jungle now. Definitely don't base. You have nothing to buy. You probably even place a ward here. You never know. Like, I don't think he's around, but he could be. As in. I think as soon as she placed the ward, like if anything, proc a passive really quick and then run. But like what you did there is like you hard committed onto a play that was already over basically, and you just not only wasted your time, you also actually went quite low. Like here before even starting the Raptors, you need to look bot. Because apparently they're really low. Since you're missing a little bit of gold, I think you should check if crab is up. You can get it. Definitely be careful though here. You really be careful. It's not okay. Like, just place a ward, leave. And then buy like an Emptom and Boots. I think Emptom and Boots is better than the alternator here. But actually, you can wait at this point, probably. Nah, just go, yeah, it's fine. I guess just clear the wolves. It's not optimal because you won't be able to sequence your Grump and wolves together, but I think clear it so you can just get level 5 from the crab then. If you're allowed to. See, like, the Lux is so far, is so close to her tower, I don't think it's the lane you should be looking at the most. Like, yeah, definitely look there every now and then, but, like, top is just also much better gank setup, you know? With the Pantheon W, so even if she's kind of under her tower, like, go there, look, you're not even looking, go from behind, just look. It's not even warded apparently the way she's playing. I mean, see, like, and then yeah, that was not the main thing I wanted you to focus on, but again, like, your cues towards the Caitlyn. Imagine you just hold Q until she has used her E and whatever, then you're actually maybe gonna hit them, you know? So far, yeah, you've missed every Q on her. Smite the crap. Check if the Raptors are up. They might be up. And then again, if you want to gank her, go from above anyways. Like, don't... Yeah, okay, they're not up. So, yeah, there might be a 2v2 though.
Probably not. Oh... Jin Zhao is a bot.
Yeah, he's somewhere there. He might even be in your jungle. I don't think he is, though. No, he didn't take anything either. Yeah, look if he's doing Drake. Check with the plant. Yeah, he is. Place your W somewhere in there. I mean, I don't think you want to steal here. No, just jungle. I think it's actually better to start at the red, but at this point finish the Raptors. Start at red and then do Crux, Raptors, and then go into your topside jungle. Also, use your E, like, yeah, use your E for clearing. Get into the habit of also, like, learning to use the auto attack reset efficiently. Just, like, attacking quicker, you know? How much gold do you need for Rocket Belt? Check. Too much. I think stay on the map here, clear to the top side, maybe again, gank top. It's just, like, abuse this lane because it's so easy. You've been there a bunch of times and it was already always kind of easy.
Jinjiao's mid.
Yeah, I think just clear now. Like, the captain for sure awarded. I don't think you'll be able to get her. But you see, right? Like, exactly what I said in the beginning. She's probably gonna push, and that's exactly what's happening. She's just perma shoving. And that's why it's so easy for you to gank her. Definitely check with the plant in a second, yeah. I don't think you should have W'd here as well because of the possibility of the Zin doing Herald. Yeah. Just try to see if you have ult up. You can literally get it now. You can literally get the eye and smite. Nice. Yeah, could have been cleaner, but that was overall good. And of course, again, if you hadn't used your W before, then maybe it would have turned out even better.
Boots or amped?
Yeah, by boots here. Or actually, Nana stops us. Wait, just wait the gold. Yeah. I think you should just wait, honestly, for the rocket belt. You're not. You're only missing 30 gold. That's like. For a whole. Wait. I mean, wait in the base. Why would you be running away? Just for a big item completion, also because there's no objective or anything up anyway, so you know you have nowhere to be. And now you have a very solid time, you know, like 10 or like before 11 minutes having your first item, it's amazing. Like, that's what you want to achieve in your games. So now you're in a good position to play the game for sure. Yeah, also, now is where you want the sweeper, so next time I'll remind you. Like, definitely get the sweeper.
She's gonna be.
Yeah, get mid.
Oh, the
wave, yeah. Wave. Like, or press tab, I guess. I don't know. I don't have the info if the Syndra has TP or not. Yeah, she doesn't, so that's why you want to get the wave. So, like, this is a kind of info you also you just need, you know.
Oh.
She's kind of low. If she keeps walking like this, you can kill her. But look at her before. Yeah. She's dead. She doesn't respect, or she doesn't have vision.
Oh, okay.
I don't know why you. I mean, she flashed anyways, but I don't know why you rocket belted first. You need to E first and then rocket belt, and then you have extra movement speed towards them, and then you can maybe reach, you know. And also, look if the crab is up. The crab is up. Get the crab first. I've told you before, anyways. Smite it.
Ah, no. I was trying to press F. That was very bad. Sorry about that.
You don't need to apologize, but yeah, that was, of course, not good. You even missed the fucking crap of it. Because the Teemo got it. Man.
That was very sad.
Definitely. I mean, now you have a much harder time fighting.
I'll go with top.
See, and imagine you could have just done crab and then like Crux, Raptors, and now into your top set, but instead you just went like down and now up again, basically. And you didn't even really sequence your camps either. Definitely look into the top set now, like his top set. I mean, and also look top, of course, as well. Like, see, the Caitlyn keeps overextending. She's just dead. Press W somewhere. Let's see. This is how you need to play it. Just throw the Q when you're in range and then go on her, right? Like, it was so much better. Go into a jungle. Like, just look if it's up. And if it's up, then get everything. Mute this Teemo as well. Yes, see if the Crux are up. They could still be up. And then if not, then just recall. Or even wait and kill the... Or look mid now, definitely, but... When I say look mid, like, really just look. Don't right-click there, just look first. And then decide if you need to right-click. That's something you do a lot. Like, okay, you can do something. You can go over the wall here.
Over here?
But definitely need vision for that. And then also place a ward maybe in the brush above you here, so you see if the Zin is coming. If she stayed, well, like now you kind of exposed yourself with the Q. And like, don't E because you want to E over the wall in a second. Stay there, like, place a W and kill her. Like, literally, you can go over alone in a second and kill her. I feel like I'm overwhelming you, but it's like, she's just rocket belt now. Rocket.
Goodness me.
Just get the crap. Get on him.
Where is he? Oh, okay.
Yeah, just get the. Could have probably smited him as well, but I think with Flashy, often just lives there. Yeah, definitely look top. I mean, yeah, you don't see her. She probably just went on her tower. So very low percent play. So just clear your jungle now. You will get your blue smite upgrade, which is nice. You're doing fine here. You could definitely be doing much better, but like you're doing fine still. Get your Grump now. It just spawned. And then you can just fully clear everything, get a nice recall. Technically, you should probably worry about the Herald spawning in a second as well, but I think in your situation right now, it's better to just clear everything and get as strong as possible. Also, like, you're kind of behind on XP. Look mid, like, look mid, there's something happening. I was about to
Oh.
say ult. Ult earlier next time. If you had ulted earlier, then like by boots here as well, by the Sorcs. If you had ulted earlier, then I don't. She might have not had Q up yet. And by sweeper now. But yeah, also here, like you really need to look at the minimap more. Like as I said. Try to actually look at the minimap after every single auto attack you're doing in the jungle. Really get into them. Yes, it will be like a thing that takes some amount of mental space in the first couple of times you do it, but trust me, it will get very easy. Like after every time you auto attack a camp in the jungle, take a quick look at the minimap and see if you need to look there. Because like there's so many times where you just don't look at the minimap and then you're just way too slow with your reactions. For example, here the Syndra was already fighting them for a couple of seconds, and you just moved there like just a bit too late. It happens so much. Yeah, just get the red at this point. I don't think. I mean, at this point, the sequencing will be fine no matter what because you cleared the camps quick enough, you know. But yeah, I mean, this is technically the optimal place. Just if you maybe need to move somewhere, then it kind of sucks if you don't have the red buff.
Should I help them?
Yeah,
Oh, actually, yeah, I should.
hard to
Because
say if you don't look there first, you know, but definitely, yeah. Go on the Caitlyn. Mean, Drake is spawning soon.
I would usually go for a base here to try and see if I can buy anything, which would have been this.
But you know that before you're, basing, you know, and you should also know that just for a recurve bow is not worth basing. The next base you should be taking here is the Nashor's sweep. Like this is where you want to sweep. You want to know if you're being spotted, if they have vision set up here. Like be aware that your team is not with you right now, so you just need to be a little bit careful. Also, like you don't even want to be here. Like get out of there. You're not achieving anything, you're literally just making yourself a target for them. Just stand behind the wall and maybe look if you can steal the Drake or something. Well, not now they know about you, of course, but. Or also just punish these kind of champs like Lux. She just flashed over the wall. Like, Lux is not a champ that is allowed to walk up to you, she's a fucking mage, you know? Actually, none of the champs in this game are allowed to walk up to you. I mean,
Yeah.
you just eat into the Lux Q, of course. Not. I mean, Zin is the only champ that's actually allowed to walk up to you in this game. If anything. Also, definitely ult there next time. Like, sure, it wouldn't have been. You probably would have died anyways, but
Yeah.
like, just
Oh, I
ult.
thought it.
Maybe you would have done something to the Caitlyn then. But of
Yep.
course, I'm sure you know that the big mistake was just eating into the Lux stuff there. Smite, 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 smite. See that again, like this term of active thinking, it needs to really be something you do. Because again, you were just walking at the Morgana completely mindlessly here, basically. There's one thing you always need to think about. If you see Morgana on your screen, what is the big thing every Morgana will do? Like, she will throw her Q at some point. Like, why do you ever get hit? You should never get hit by a Morgana Q, by a Lux Q, or whatever, when you have your E up and, like, they're at this kind of range that they're at in these situations, you know? You should just really, not a single time you should get hit by those random things. Especially, like, even without E, you should be able to sidestep, but especially with E, you should just genuinely never get hit, because you have a movement spell that with which you're able to react to it. Like, I don't know if you maybe feel like you have generally kind of slow reactions. I don't know if there's good ways to improve that, but I mean, you are playing a lot of League. I think generally, just by playing, you should be able to get better reactions. Just Q. Again, I mean, you were in a pretty good position to play this game, but I mean, in this game, I think it was mostly really mechanical mistakes and whatever that happened that cost you quite hard, but still, also a bunch of decision-making mistakes for sure. Or, like, yeah, a bunch of, like, inefficiencies that added up, you know, and then you just lost a lot of the tempo that you could have had, because you actually got some kills in the early game and whatever, you had a solid first item timing. So I think this is definitely a Lich Bane game. I mean, if you really enjoy playing with Nashor's more, then you can always build it. But I think in these kind of games, like, I've been enjoying Lich Bane personally more anyways, but yeah.
Oh.
Like, see again what I said earlier, like, you're so ready to use a 5-minute cooldown instead of your, like, E and your, like, okay, 45-second cooldown rocket belt. And then also you made the decision to go in here after you tanked Lux E for no reason, you know? Like, you were half HP, and then you decided to go in. And the half HP should have never even happened, because you just walked into a Lux E that was already there the whole time. Like, this kind of stuff is just like, you just gotta ask yourself, why is it even happening, you know? Because I'm more than certain that if I ask you now, like, is it good to step into Lux E and go to half HP, then you would of course say no, right? But, like, you still do it for some reason. Like, really ask yourself, why do you still do these kind of very obvious mistakes? I guess just try to get as many camps while, again, Drake is spawning. It's just not a good position. I guess you can get the crowd, yeah, like, we can't see because of, you need to press tab more, you need to get the actual timings, you know? It's a big difference if it's in spawning in 1 minute or in 30 seconds, but both of them are just gonna look gray on the map. You could have easily cleared your one more camp or two more camps here and gotten an extra needlessly large rod that might help you in the next fight. Stay on him, stay on him. You're in a 4v2. And, like, be careful, like, where are you going now? Look what your team is doing, look your own HP. You're literally just walking into certain death, basically. Could have ulted back there probably, but she has Sonya's anyways. Need to ult.
My bad. Well,
I mean, yeah, it is your bad, but it's like, can you answer me this question if I ask you, like, why do you think all of these mistakes that I'm more than certain you know that they're mistakes, right? But why do they happen, and why do they happen so much as well, right? It's not like you do these kind of really obvious mistakes all like every now and then. It's like you do them so much, right? And especially the later the game went here, like, maybe you're a little bit discouraged or whatever, but, like, still, You know, like this game is probably winnable still, technically. Like it's definitely not looking good, but it's technically probably winnable. Like these guys are making a lot of positioning mistakes. Whenever you're in a position where if a squishy target is half HP, you can still kill them, you know? And like sure, mechanics might be missing or whatever for you a little bit, but like these kind of kills are not difficult to get, you know? You just need to do it. Definitely, again, like make the decision. You can't fight here. Like, okay, maybe with W if he steps in it, but now, just leave. You know, he will beat you. Go to your top set. It's literally a whole kill that is sitting on the top set the whole time here as well, for a long time. And especially in your position, you want to get as much as possible. Like, you need to get everything you can. Because at this point, it's actually not your jungle anymore. Like, it shouldn't be. Oh, got the Caitlyn. Look where she is. Didn't matter here, but again, like, W, you know? Somewhere. Maybe technically it's correct to not W, but I think you should, just for the habit of it, you should still W, just so you actually get into the habit of doing it. Also, place W before you get into vision. And then think about Lux Q, think about Lux Q. Think about Lux Q, think about Xin Zhao W, think about Morgana Q. Well, and like that's a thing that's more excusable not to think about is the Zhonya's, I guess. Of course, that definitely killed you here, but
I was
like
rooting,
the
otherwise I would have been able to ult. I was rooting in the
yeah,
last second.
but the general thing that you already did wrong here before the Morgana even Zhonya's is to E onto her, you know, before your return Q even applied the second stack. Like, I mean, okay, at this point you probably can finish her off with E, but then you probably could have been quicker as well with it.
Yeah.
Think about her Q. See the, like see how easy it is to get there, these kills. Yeah, get Nash, get Nash, get Nash. Ping your team, like hard ping. Maybe even type if you see nobody moving. Like you can get Nash 100% here. Yeah, literally you and Teemo, you can get Nash. You don't need anyone else.
Should I
Just
start?
start. Yeah, just start. Just start. Place W as well here, like it's not gonna be contested. Syndra really doesn't need to TP, but whatever, better than not getting it, I guess. Like, see, nobody's any is up still for the next. Like, now they're up. The support is up now. Seems like that would have mattered. Like, now game is 100% winnable. I guess you definitely need to just be careful with it. Like, just group up mid now, honestly. Tell your team to group up mid. Like, ping for help. Even maybe. Fuck the sidelines, like tell the Syndra to come to you. Just get the mid tower. See if someone mispositions, try to punish them. Make sure the Q hits the wave, of course. Place W somewhere at the tower. Kill the Lux, kill the Lux. What's she doing?
Oh dear.
Why, oh dear, just kill them. If you had like eat on the Morgana, you probably live there as well. And if the Syndra was there, you probably just would have asked them here. Could have gotten Elder. I mean, that's definitely not good now that you died and Elder is spawning when you're spawning. Ping the Elder, especially because Syndra is actually in a 7 on Kul'Chatra and she's your strongest member. Definitely bad that she was in the side lane. By Blasting Wand, you need the white stuff here.
Oh, yeah. The only one who's built MR is Jinjo.
Yeah, but you kind of need it against him. I mean, could actually go for Lich Bane as well. But I think this, like, White Staff is never bad. Like, even against base MR, it's good.
Oh dear. Well, maybe not. Oh dear.
Ult, ult, ult. Just apply this. Don't start the Elder though, like you're not doing Elder, you're fighting. Place your W, like just keep placing your W in these fights. You know, like no, but obviously towards the enemies, you know. Somewhere where it might catch them or where you might want to engage them. Yeah, I mean not just push bot or something. Right now you're not doing Elder. Like, you know, I mean, understand that you're a champion. You can kill all of them if they walk into your range. And like, the way you're not gonna die is by using your W, and like E-ing on top of her here instead of E-ing back.
Goodness, I doubled it.
At this point, just wait for your ult before you do anything. 10 seconds. And get your story, yeah, get level 16 as well, especially important. You need to play so much more like fishing W's where you're just looking if people step into it. At this point, your W's not even that long of a cooldown anymore. Yeah, like this kind of W is good, right? Like, of course, you need to position yourself in a way where you can even do something with it, but just keep placing these kind of W's. And then, of course. You just as Echo especially, you just can't get hit by those random Qs, you know, like you really shouldn't. You have your E to dodge it, you have your ult to dodge it even if you don't have your E. So like these kind of mistakes, there's no other way around it to just play better mechanically. And like I guess a big part of it is of course also awareness, right? Like when I actually told you think about Morgana, Q, you actually managed to think about it, right? And you didn't get hit by it. But you need to do that yourself the whole time, every single time when you're playing a game, and not just against Morgana, like against every champ. Like some champs, for sure, it's more important to think about their abilities than others, but still. And now you're just kind of through the game again, when you're actually in a pretty good position to win. Clear the mid minions and get white stuff. Clear something. You need 100 gold. Get it and then see if you maybe can contest Nash. Probably not because they have Elder, but definitely get the white stuff. You need to be as strong as possible. Yeah, that's good, but you need to stay in a position where you can also follow up on it if you can, you know? Like, don't place your W and then run away. Place your W on him. Only ult like that if you really need to, like you didn't need to ult here. You did get him without even hitting your ult, so it was obviously wasted. There's W behind her before even doing anything. And again, like for them, place W somewhere behind them and then just kill them. You will kill them. Well, if they don't react at least. Then think about like what's the spell you need to think about every Ezreal Q. So like just don't walk in straight lines at him. You will hit them only then. But yeah, like just keep him like just leave him at this point. You're probably not gonna kill him. He's not that stupid. So just clear waves. I mean, Nash is definitely. I guess it's something you could look at because there's Zen is
As
still
long as they
dead.
are Kai'Sa, I can do
And
it.
now sweep as well. You need to know if you're being spotted on the way there. And like, don't clear the ward before looking if the Nash is being done. Like, it could be still be done, honestly. I don't think it is, but. Yeah, just like, I don't know, clear your jungle here. Like, clear the waves, honestly. Like, clear the jungle because it takes 1 second, but the important thing is clearing the waves. Yeah, look, they're trolling, they're trolling. Just kill them. Place W, place W. Why are you so tunnel visioned on the Morgana when she's still late? See, you were so tunnel visioned on her that you literally just basically stasis with her, you know? Like, she stasis, she used her Zhonya's, and then you did nothing. Just go on the Caitlyn with your E. Like, she was in range as well. Literally go on her. You saw how fast you kill her before, so, like, why not just do it again? And then, like, you know, there's really. You basically went AFK in that fight because we were only focused on killing the support, which shouldn't be your main focus, anyways. And yeah, she was kind of free there, but, like, after she used her Zhonya's, just, like, don't freeze and do nothing. Just.
Jeez.
You need to get better at adapting as well. Like, there's so many things, and I don't want to tell you everything because you need to be able to focus on something to even start improving on it. So, like, the big thing is really the W, and, like, even still in this game, there was a bunch of situations where you needed to use W, especially in those, like, fights at Elder. But so much also just about thinking about everything, honestly, but especially about enemy abilities. Man, people in this healer are so bad at ending games, this is so painful.
Should I have gotten Magi's?
No. I think at this point, sell your Darkseal probably for some other item when you can afford one. Yeah, just clear your jungle here. Or, like, nah, the clear waves, honestly, at this point, I think it's more important. And sure, clear this because it's 1Q, but clear mid wave and whatever so they can't just push. And then I guess sell your dark, like get the last city. It matters, you know. Like recall and get banshees, and
Banshees.
preferably do it out of vision. Yeah. Why would you ever stand in vision when you could literally like take a quarter of a second more, and then not get cancelled? You know, like this is also such small things, but there's so many things where I just really don't understand the reasoning behind it, and it feels like there just is none, you know. Yeah, I think Banshee is gonna help you a lot against like Morgana, Lux, these kind of champs. Not today instantly. Of course, now you need to be even more aware of spells like Ezreal Q, so just like don't walk into his range that much so he can get your spell shield very easily with that. No, W somewhere like. I mean, well, more towards below somewhere where the other ones are, I guess, at this point. Are they doing Elder? Like, you need to check. She's dead here. You're, like, focusing the only person with MR on their team, by the way, when you can literally one-shot every single other person. Yeah, I feel like I overwhelmed you in this fight. It's like, man, it's so difficult. Like, giving active advice in fights and whatever is impossible. Especially with, like,
Yeah.
where you are at right now with your gameplay, but it's like, just another thing, just think, you know, like, okay, the Ezreal also bottom R, but every single other person you can literally just one-shot. And again, like, Morgana also, to think about the fact that she has Zhonya, so the Lux, for example, I don't think she has Zhonya, so, yeah, nice and edge on the Zin with the Sinra's writing, it's kind of true, you know? Could have easily just killed the Lux if she was in your range.
Yeah.
There's so many things to work on, and, like, honestly, I mean, we've had a bunch of sessions, I don't even know if I would say that a lot of the stuff really improved. Like, sure, some of the stuff maybe improved, but, like, the big things are still there, you know? Like, the W, massive, just in general, thinking, like, is it difficult for you? Like, is it really difficult for you, you feel like, thinking actively? Or what's the problem? I know it's a difficult to answer question, but it's like...
Yeah, it's quite hard, because, I mean, I have played, but I have played really badly for quite a while.
Mm-hmm.
So...
Did you start in 2021?
Very minuscule. Pardon?
Did you start in 2021? Or did you play before that on another account?
I played 1 year before that, so 2020.
Okay. So, I mean, you have improved a little bit.
Yeah. But it's gonna... I think it will take me, like, quite a few more games for me to, like, fully improve, like, completely.
Yeah, but, I mean, we have had coaching sessions before, you know, and it's like... Just, like, there's just something missing in your, like, mindset towards the game, I guess. I don't know, like... Because clearly you want to improve. Like, if you would just tell me... Like, you wouldn't even tell me that because you wouldn't even be getting a coaching session. But clearly you want to improve because you're getting these coaching sessions. Like, you just... It feels like you need to put in more effort, you know? Like, you really need to put in more effort thinking and whatever. Like, the way you're playing, it's like how most of the... As I said, like, how most of the people in your ELO probably play. They just play a little bit, have fun, like, turn their brain off, basically, you know? Press their buttons and whatever, but, like... To really improve and, like, do the right, make the right, like, genuinely the right decisions and whatever, you just need to actively think. And, like, of course, you won't be able to do it perfectly all of a sudden. And if you would be able to do that, then you would, of course, just, like, skyrocket your ELO. But, like, there needs to be this, like, it's just not visible. And, like, how many coaching sessions have we had? Like, three or four even?
Three.
So, like... And during that time, I think, like, the most important thing, and what I've said every single time with, like, the active thinking, I feel like it that's just, like, the big thing that's not really improved. So, like,
right.
And the only thing I can tell you about that is to, like, do it, you know? Like, really do it. Like, when you are in the game, like, maybe I need to think of some, like, techniques or whatever, or, like, good ways to get into the habit of doing it. But, like, the thing to how you can actively think is to just, like, see an enemy champion on your screen, like, just enemy champions for now. Like, there's so many other things you can think about, but, like, the big thing for you is just, like, seeing those champions and then just trying to put yourself in their place, you know? Have you played, like, I mean, I think for you a big problem might also be that you're only playing Echo, honestly. Have you only played Echo in other seasons as well?
Yeah.
Mostly, right? Maybe, like, try, like, have you, do you like playing ARAM?
Yeah.
Do you do it also, though?
Yeah, I do sometimes when I feel like I am just, I tend to play often in ARAMs.
Yeah, I see. You play every now and then. I think ARAM is a good way to at least get some amount of feel for other champs, you know? But, like, I think just the fact that you only play Echo, it's definitely also something that's probably holding you back. I think I had someone very recently that I coached that was also very similar to you. Like, they also only played Echo, and then there's just so much basic stuff missing because you're kind of... you're just so focused, you're just so used to this one playstyle that, like, a lot of the more general stuff just goes by the, like, what's the right word, like... It's just the focus on that is just too low, you know, because your focus is only on how you play with Echo and not just how you play League of Legends. That's how it feels like. And I mean, if you had never played ARAM, then I would have told you just, like, try to play more ARAM. I guess still maybe try to play more ARAM, but also maybe just try learning another champ that you enjoy. Like, maybe just try finding there's other champs and, like, really just expand your horizons, I guess, in that way. it will give you a better understanding, 100%. And like maybe also just only like, sure, we all love Echo. It's a very nice champ, but even I personally, I get burnt out only playing Echo at some point, and like the enjoyment definitely diminishes after some time. I really only play Echo, so I don't know if it's the same for you, but like, is it the same for you, or do you really just like you can queue up Echo every single game? It's not a big deal.
I mean, if I don't feel like I want to play Echo, that's when I go into ARAMS.
Mm.
That's what I tend to do. I don't try to go. I should probably do more Summoner's Rift with other champions.
Mm.
But I haven't really been. The ones I have is like Zed and Kane.
Yeah.
That was like, I haven't played them for quite a while now.
Yeah, especially I see. Like this season, you've genuinely only played Echo.
Yeah.
Like the last split, you also played some Zed games, some Kane games. Maybe like learn Kane as well or whatever. I don't know. It's like, I think it's only gonna be beneficial. Or maybe learn a champ with a completely different playstyle, like a Zac or something as well. See if that and then like, I don't know. It's just it really, as I said, it's so difficult for me. What's like the main cause of this to really understand where it comes from. Because it's clearly like something that's just massively holding you back, because you're putting in the time, right? Like with the time you're putting in, you could definitely be improving a bit more. It's just there needs to be that one click or whatever. But I mean, I've told you a bunch of times already, I think it's just like you need to put in more effort actively thinking, but apparently it's kind of difficult for you, right? It seems that way, that it's just difficult for you.
When there's a lot happening, that's when it gets a bit overwhelming. But when mm-hmm. Because as a result of that, I tend to, that's where like the tunnel vision mind comes mm-hmm. in. Because when there's a lot happening, it's kind of hard for me to notice.
Yeah.
But then again,
yeah, it's you need to take it one step at a time. I'm just thinking like how can you take it one step at a time? I think like one step at a time would be, for example, to really just start thinking about the enemy when you're in a 1v1, at least, you know. In a 1v1, there's not too much happening, but even then sometimes it feels like you're not actively thinking enough about it, you know. Like, for example, when you're running at, like, the Morgana, when you're running at the Lux or whatever, and they're basically on their own, it's fine that if you tunnel vision on them, just be able to adapt if they, for example, Zhonya's or this kind of stuff, you know? And like, while you're tunnel visioning on them, obviously, like, if there's another champ around that can CC you, but like, this is the kind of stuff that it will come with time, you know? Like, being able to play around all the champs, but, like, at the moment, it seems like oftentimes you're not even playing around the one champ you're fighting. And like that's really something that needs to start happening. And the more you get into the habit of doing that, the easier it's gonna be to just get into like getting a bigger picture and whatever. Like sometimes I also struggle with that. You know, like sometimes when I feel like I have an off day, I just struggle to see what's really going on in the fights and whatever. It happens, but like this basic thing in your mind where you really need to think about all the possibilities. It just needs to be there on a basic level, and for you it feels like sometimes it's not even there on a basic level, you know? Like, not all the time, but like oftentimes it really, most of your mistakes that are happening and like most of your deaths and whatever, they really just feels like the big reason for that is just because it feels like you're just not thinking at all, or like,
okay.
Because I don't think you're thinking and coming to the wrong conclusions, you know? I think you're really thinking, you're just really not thinking in a lot, with a lot of the decisions you're making. And then, like, another, like, there's so many, like, there's one, genuinely, like, 100 things I could tell you, but one thing I also noticed, like, when I told you, like, to look somewhere, instead of looking, you already just right-click there, you know? Like, it's just such a wrong mindset. You need to look there, like, genuinely look and then make your decisions. Because you're making so many decisions without even having the info, you know? That's another, like, big thing. So I think that the main things I want you to work on is really just get into the habit of using your W, because it's still something that you, like, okay, you did it a little bit better this game because I was also here and whatever, but, you know, like, when you're on your own, you really
be
just...
Be more active with it more.
Yeah, 100%. Like, use it, like, understand the fact that it's a fucking broken spell, you know? It's a really, really good spell. Not broken, but it's, like, a really, really good spell. There's a reason it's Echo's highest cooldown spelling. It's, like, except for his ult, of course, but, like, it's a really high cooldown spell, and the reason for that is because it's so, so good. So the fact that you're playing so many games without it is just main reason why your deaths are so high and you're just losing a lot of games. And then, like, I think farming is not even something I want you to worry about, honestly. Like, I think there's bigger things to work on, but like the decision making, just like start making decisions when you actually have info.
Like,
you make so many decisions without any info because you're just not looking there, you know? So I think those are like the two main things, because as I said, there's so many things, but you need to just take it one step at a time. And I think these are like the two biggest things for you that are gonna help you win more games in your current ELO. So yeah, and then like, yeah, just like think, just try to actively think about every champion. If you don't understand like a certain champ, how to play against them, you really just don't understand for some reason, then like ask me on Discord or whatever, you know, then I'll try to explain how to play against them. But like most of these champs are very similar, you know, like most of the, there's like a bunch of different categories of champs. There's champs like Master Yi, I don't know, Belveth, Yone, like all of these champs, you kind of want to keep your distance. Don't let them auto-attack you too much. And then there's champs like Lux, Morgana, where they usually have like this one spell, Xerath, that you really need to be aware of. And then if you manage to dodge that, they're basically dead, you know? Like, they should be dead. If you're playing Echo, at least, you know? Like, you should be able to punish them after that. And then there's obviously ADCs and this kind of stuff as well. But like, ADCs are kind of similar to the other ones. ADCs are, of course, kind of similar to champs like Yone or whatever, just that they have more range, you know? So you still don't want to let them auto-attack you a lot. So you just need to pick your engages a bit, like your engage range a little bit differently.
Sometimes there is like a fed MF and then she can just kill me with two autos.
Yeah, so she can't if you use your W. And if you get on her and you're not in a super bad position, you can just one-shot her before she does that to you, you know? Echo is quicker at dealing his damage than any other champ in the game, honestly. If you're really quick with your Rocket Ball combos, I don't think there's many champs that can deal their damage as quickly, at least not with the range that Echo has. Like, I really can't think of anyone. Like, sure, there's other assassins like a Zed or whatever, they can also deal their damage very quickly, but it's not at the same kind of range, to be honest. So yeah, I really hope, like, as I said, I know this is a lot, like, there's tons of things I told you. Of course, I will upload this session to YouTube or whatever, but just like the big things I want you to focus on: use your W in every fight, think about the game, like think about mainly the enemies, but of course the more you can think about the better. There's tons of things you can think about, but like the main thing, really, just especially when we once try to actively think about the enemy, what can they even do. If you really don't understand some champions, then like maybe look them up or whatever anyways. And then just like make decisions based on information you have, you know? Like don't make decisions before you have information, because that's something I also noticed, and probably in every session so far as well, where you just click somewhere and then like after you already clicked there, you just realize that you probably shouldn't have done that, you know?
Okay.
So yeah. I hope this wasn't too much. I hope it was helpful. And as always, if you have any more questions or whatever, you can definitely ask me on Discord.